Welcome back to Waypoint. I have grown as a person over the 72 hours.
You have.
Yeah.
Seen some shit. I have seen some anime.
Yeah.
I have role played.
Yeah.
I can add things to my life deck.
Yeah.
It's been an experience.
It's been a team building experience.
It has been a team building experience.
It really actually has. I was going to say something about, like, I'm so glad we did this.
Me too.
Because I feel like I know you guys better.
Like, we've
and I still like you,
we've
and that's good.
Our own personal E3.
We really have.
Like, not to, like no. into the weeds. Like, when you go to a thing like E3, it's like, you were tired.
Yes.
Like, you go out to parties. Like, you're up late. Like, you're working
you
so
hard.
You meet
weird people. You meet cool people. You're exhausted. You're on.
Yes.
And we didn't have that, except we just had it in the last.
We had it.
And they're still having it.
We're in the middle of it.
We're still doing it. Also, we got that much
hey,
to go.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Hell yeah, happy Halloween.
Like, my birthday's all right. Halloween's better.
Yes.
Halloween's
better.
Damn good.
God damn right.
So we're going to continue before Austin and I take a break.
A little bit of a break.
But we are riding high.
Off of that.
Off the dag.
Dag, rest in peace.
Dag.
RIP 2016 to 2016.
Yeah.
Dag lived.
But I don't know.
Five
Son
hours.
Of Dag.
People in the chat are going to get this real quick. Let me just take it. Dag is up there with Laser Ted. Two musicians in the sky putting together a duet that is going on in role-playing game heaven right now. It's perfect. It's beautiful. Yeah.
Is there like three people that understand what Laser
Ted
is?
No, Laser Ted is like was like my riffraff character in the.
Oh, that's what we were talking about at the beginning.
Yes.
That maybe you were going to adopt that character a second time.
Yes. I didn't because I wanted Dag to shine. I wanted Dag to be the superstar, and I could be the schlub who's his best friend.
Yeah, my first time through, I appreciate you that.
Got a star. You got to shine when you see a star. You got to let it shine. It's late. We're tired.
Yep.
If somehow you didn't see that, there will be archives. Like, people have been asking this the whole time. Like, there'll be archives of everything. Things that you're excited about that you missed. There are clips going out. There are socials. There are, you know, Steve Fobosh, Kim, our other social human.
Yep.
That is taking clips and things. All this stuff you're going to be able to see if you've not seen it live. And there's been a lot of really awesome segments at Weird Hours of the Night. Weird Hours of the Day. It'll all be up eventually, but
I think with the last 12 hours, and I started that last segment with this, but just like
some weird shit's happened today.
There's a cow.
Uh-huh.
Chief Keef went into VR.
Yep.
Yes.
Patrick did his first. Patrick and Danielle and Danica all did their first role-playing game.
Very
it was fantastic.
First.
We have. It's just been Prodigy came through. We played Mafia 3. That happened today.
Yes.
Wow.
Again, that feels
forever ago.
It was like weeks ago.
We did an N64 tournament today.
We walked him through.
We had a GoldenEye tournament today.
And we played Perfect Dark. Like, so much has happened.
A lot has happened.
Now we're going to go back to something a little more familiar, though.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah. Now we're going to, you know, feel like in this last. Look at this. There are no more days left.
That's the best
that
part.
That is 10
that's the best part.
Fucking hours. That is a great feeling.
Yeah.
We're literally, you can actually say home stretch. 10 hours
over
the course of 72 is a home stretch.
Absolutely.
Right.
Especially when I'm asleep for at least three of those.
Yep. Can't wait.
We're gonna be returning to some of the games that people have been, segments they've enjoyed, games that we want to go back to. And one of those is Alien Isolation, which we didn't quite see the alien last night.
We saw the tail of the alien.
We did see the tail of the alien in a cutscene, so we're going to get a little bit further.
Yep.
Right.
So we're going to load that up now and play that for a little while. So.
I'm doing a tweet-a-rooney. Just letting people
know. Oh, good call.
Let them know that Dag has moved on.
Dag has moved on.
Oh, we need all. We need
everyone else.
Sebastopol.
Can we get the speaker?
I might
here?
Just be able to do it. It's out here.
It's the third one.
It's the bottom third one. It's the bottom one.
I think so.
You got it. I'll let you do it, bro.
All right. So this game was one of my favorite games of 2014.
I'm still not hearing anything.
Yep. Can you like make something?
We need to hear this alien hurting us.
You may be able to hear it through the stream. We're just making sure for folks that are watching that we're able to hear it.
Coming through that PC. Oh, but yeah, this is one of my favorite games of 2014. I think it's too long.
So, yeah, interesting. So,
it's
yeah,
a little
you,
too
didn't
long.
Play with, you didn't play with us last night.
Was that last night?
It was last night.
It was last night.
Okay.
And also, as I said that, I was like, did I somehow forget Danielle was there
as I
said that?
No.
I was like, but I know we've talked about Alien Isolation.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it's a phenomenal horror game.
Yes.
So worth playing.
Yes.
But I also would tell people to give up about six, 7 hours in. Like,
you don't need to play.
Seeing what the game has to offer, yeah. Okay. Not a whole lot changes after that. And in a really unfortunate way, because I think it's a gorgeous game.
Yes.
It's scary as hell.
Oh, yes.
But it just kind of hits you over the head with those tricks over and over again. Like, it tries to justify that $60 price point. Maybe not even the $60 price point, but the amount of money they probably invested in this game.
Yeah.
Sure.
To a degree that really wears out its welcome, where I wanted the game to be over, and I was like, it is rare to get a game of this caliber. Like, this is basically Amnesia the Dark Descent given a AAA budget.
Yes.
Which does not take anything away from Amnesia, which is also one of my favorite horror games.
And also just everything great about Alien.
Totally.
Which is that world.
And
that
Alien
sort of
1,
blue
like,
color,
yes.
Filth and grime to it, and, you know, cool, awesome woman character, which is always nice, you
yep.
know, especially in a horror property. So like, all the good things about Alien that you love, and all the good things about Amnesia the Dark Descent that are great and amazing, that were paradigm yes. shifting, if you want to use the
I mean,
buzzword.
In terms
you know.
Of the horror genre,
exactly.
it absolutely was.
Exactly.
Like, Amnesia was not the first game to introduce the idea of hiding from an enemy, but it was the, I would probably say the first game to make that the central mechanic
yeah.
and also punish you. Like, what's unique about Amnesia is the fact that it not only were you hiding, you were also punished for hiding.
Yes.
The thing right. you were asked to do also killed you.
I mean, it also just ushered in a bunch of first-person horror games, which just seems like a simple thing, but at the time, like, the perspective for most horror games was this third-person Japanese-influenced Resident Evil, Silent
Survival
Hill.
Survival horror style.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm not saying, again, that there were never any first-person horror games before that at all. I mean, if you go back to something like even System Shock, it has its roots in a sort of horror.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's a big, big shooter also.
We still can't hear out here either. Maybe it's being worked
on. All right, cool.
Okay.
And so even that ushered in again and again and again tons of first-person horror games. And so then it was really cool to see a big budget attempt to move into that space
yes.
where the player is disempowered. I'm saying this based on just what I've heard from you both, obviously.
Yeah.
What I'm seeing
yeah.
and what I've seen
yeah.
yesterday and today is like, oh wow, like this is what that sort of game can look like with a ton of resources put
yes.
behind it.
Yeah, it was like a really weird position to be in when I was reviewing it because it's like I wanted, you know, I was a giant bomb at the time, and like, so I had to give it a, you know, an actual like score value.
Right.
And I wanted to give it 5 stars because there were like, if this game was 7 hours long, 6 hours long, it was a 5-star
yes.
game.
Yes.
But then it kept going.
And then it kept going. And then it kept going.
And there are some things at the end that are just bullshit. Like, that's the real.
It gets really cheap.
It gets cheap.
It it finds artificial ways to extend the narrative.
Exactly.
Like, I remember sitting down being like, and my wife's like, okay, like, are we almost done? And I'm like, I'm pretty sure this is it. Like, this seems like a conclusion sequence.
Yeah.
And then it's not.
There's more.
And then you're like, oh, this is another 3 hours. And she's yep. like, I'm going upstairs and I don't want to play this game anymore.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, reasonable.
I can imagine that reviewing this game would have been hell on earth. Playing this in a like condensed period of time.
You didn't have to review it.
I did not review. I was
right.
pissed off, actually. I guess I can say that. I did not agree with the review that my website at the time published.
That happens all the time.
Yeah, that's just part of
it. It happens. It's
people
okay.
People have different experiences about with games, and like that's
yes.
we have different tolerances for
yes.
certain things, and we have preferences.
Yes,
and
we do.
Options.
We're people, damn it.
P&Os.
Right, yeah. P&Os.
You know? But I could imagine that reviewing this game under the time pressure that people have to review games in would have sucked and
yep.
really taken away a lot of my enjoyment. I took my time with it. Like, I played it over a series of nights. I streamed
sure.
a bunch of it, which was also a really fun way of playing this, for sure.
Totally.
Especially the more frustrating sequences,
right.
where I was just sort of like, I can laugh
you
about
can have
this
some fun
and
with
chat.
It.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But I can imagine that, like, having to play this in, like, a few days.
A rush, yeah.
Would have actually
sucked. You know, fortunately, like, Giant Bomb, like, if you get the games late, you know, we didn't have to
That's
rush
cool.
out to hit an embargo.
Yeah.
So it's, but
yeah.
I was still, you know, over the course of, you know, maybe 5 or 6 days, like playing through it. And eventually I was playing it during the day because I was like, I just don't have enough now hours
right.
in the night.
Yeah.
I asked someone, I remember asking, it might've been like whoever, maybe Phil Kohler or someone who reviewed it. I asked someone who I knew was reviewing, I was like, hey, I'm pretty close to the end. They're like, ha, 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 ha. It was like a bunch
yep.
of LOLs
yeah.
when I asked if I was almost done. Which at that point I was like, all right, I'm gonna have to play this game during the day.
Yep.
Which
really
is not
robbed
ideal.
It a lot of tension.
Yeah.
yeah.
This is a night game. This is a 1:30, whatever time it is,
1:45
game.
I was like, hey, shout out to Phil Kohler.
Great guy.
Great guy, and I, again, probably wouldn't be here without Phil Kohler. I did a bunch of stuff with the stream friends. Yeah. Phil's like side streaming
group. Turn it up a little more?
Yeah, just a little bit. We have sound now.
So we do have sound now, yeah. So I'll actually stop rotating around this room.
We'll stop
just filling time.
I wouldn't be here without Phil either. Phil is the reason I started at Polygon in the first place. Awesome. I'd still be at the ACLU.
Well, you know what? Phil wouldn't be here without me. So you all have to thank me.
It's all because of you, Patrick. Because he was at 1UP, wasn't he?
Yeah, when I left to go to MTV, then
I forgot about that. That's true.
Yeah, and then he was a news editor. He hated it.
Of course.
I'm shocked.
We've done the news editor gig.
Yeah, it's rough.
Especially when
we're. Or if it's not your thing.
Right, that's the thing. It's like, there are people who do it. I think right now, Polygon Allegra Frank is just like.
Oh, she's killing it.
Does news all day.
Killing it.
There are people who used to be at Joystick, Jordan Mallory, just does news all day.
Yeah.
Like that, you're
Chris
built
Ligman.
For. Chris Ligman.
Awesome interview news.
Right, perfect. Yes. Absolutely. Yes. And Chris does it with a spin, which is really
Chris is
good.
Amazing.
Like,
I used to
really
work with
like
Chris.
A voice. Totally.
They are wonderful. Yeah.
And so, but if that's not what you want to do, if what you want to do is like do deep dives into games and do criticism
or
do long form journalism, it can be, rough.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Anyway, where were we? Oh, right. Things were getting fucking terrifying.
This game caused some serious screaming, some mild panic, and I loved every damn second of it.
Well, it makes me so upset because it seems so unlikely that we're gonna get a sequel.
Right.
Yeah, I know. I honestly think the problem was that the Creative Assembly indulged. I'm not even sure if it was entirely the like, well, it needs to be X hours. I think it was like, no, we need every one of these things.
Right.
We need all of this stuff.
Oh, okay. This is a big moment.
I actually hated this part.
Yeah, it's bad.
This
part. Whoa!
Actually, maybe it is too loud.
It is a little loud.
Lower. Yeah. Sorry, folks. Sorry, production friends.
Third one, yeah. Bottom. There you go.
Too low? Good?
No, I think you're okay.
Thank you, guys.
I got it, man.
Yeah, this part is actually really hard and kind of sucks.
Or maybe a little higher than that, huh?
Oh, you mean a little low?
Yeah, I think I should raise it a little higher than that.
No. It's actually just really quiet right now in the game. As long as you can hear the footsteps.
Yeah, I can hear the footsteps.
Let's see if I can not totally mess up this bad human part. So the human parts of this game are not good.
Okay. Yeah, they're not great. God, my first 2 hours of this game, I looked at every poster.
I bet.
At every texture.
Oh,
I
God, there's so much amazing art in this game.
So good. I'm also a huge Alien fan, and I know you're an Alien fan as well, Patrick. Are you an Alien?
I'm.
It's my favorite
sorry.
Movie of all time.
I am.
Yeah.
It's a fantastic movie. It's
Here's the question. Okay, maybe it's already answered, but I feel like it actually says a lot about people and their film preferences if you ask Alien versus Aliens.
Yeah, it does.
Which is, that doesn't say that one is better than the others.
Totally.
They're totally different types of films that take place technically in the same universe.
Totally.
Because one's an action film and one's a horror film.
Yep.
Yes.
But I feel like if you ask a person, like, which one do you prefer, it, like, gives you, like, a really good sense of, like, their personality. And
you know
like
what's up?
Totally. I think an alien.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
By far.
Welcome to Waypoint.
Back aliens, peoples, are monsters.
Right.
I'm being condescending
despite
about it.
What
no,
we
that's
just said.
Totally
I
true.
I love aliens, too.
Yeah.
I also love aliens, too. I just think the first is a far superior, more rich, richly layered, richly textured movie.
It is. Like, I think textured is a really great
also think, I think it holds up better than Aliens does.
Oh, definitely.
As, like, a film.
Yes.
Like, Aliens is still fun.
Yes.
But Alien is still, like, a better film right now. Yeah.
Well, and it doesn't, I think like the lessons it taught about tension and about pacing are still really relevant. Whereas action films have gone in a different direction. Not to say that the way action is depicted in Aliens is bad. It's just the current state doesn't reflect, doesn't look like Aliens in film at least, as much as it does, as much as the kind of like horror genre still owes to Alien.
Absolutely.
That said, in video games, I think Aliens is deeply influential, like maybe more influential to the way video games handle sci-fi action.
I agree with that completely.
Completely hot take city right now. We're just making shit up.
I think you're right. So.
But it's 1:50 a.m. I'm here to make shit
up. We've been here for more than 60 hours at this
That's
point.
That's true. We have not left this office.
Actually, we haven't left this office. It was before then. It's not like we got here at noon.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
I think I looked it up, and I think. We all are working like 130-hour week.
Okay, well, I heard the word comp day tossed around earlier.
I think
so that's
a good Yeah, that's a good thing.
We're gonna get these days back, do not worry.
Pretty happy about that.
Me too, we just have to figure out when. Whoa,
there's a human.
He should see you.
Yeah.
But I'm crouching.
Is that what that is?
I'm crouching.
See, the alien will like smell you.
You just
oh shit.
Were you crouching?
I was.
Okay. He definitely, yeah.
I actually like, oh shit.
This is gonna attract the alien though. These people are so stupid. The alien is like, I hear stuff.
I did not.
Oh lord.
So I have to find an energy cell?
Yeah, this part blows, actually. A little bit.
Can you actually look up where I find the energy cell?
What is this game called? Alien Isolation?
Yeah.
Energy cell?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, well, I guess I can just run.
Is this the Lorenz lobby system? What is this?
It's after the first train.
Are you trying to hack the elevator?
He needs the tool. He needs the scanner right now.
Finding the data cell?
Yes.
Oh yeah, there's crafting in this game. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
God, I remember there were times in this game I was so tense.
So you have to go get that device that you got before, right?
Yes.
Yeah, he has to do that.
Run up the stairwell, crouch down up there, head straight back. Elevator should now be behind you. Make a left up there, head straight. Little lobby room. I think you just have to get that thing and then get past, like through that room where that dude was.
I'm pretty sure I cheesed this, to be honest, when I played it.
Okay.
I think I grabbed it and I ran and like got to a somewhat safe place before the alien was alerted by the gunfire stuff.
Okay.
This was on launch day that I played like this section, so. Like October 14th of last, something like that. I remember being very excited. Counting down the days and getting this game.
Over here, someone's here.
That's not good. All right, so you're grabbing the thing.
Yeah, I grabbed that. Then most people come up on the left-hand side.
Circuits are fried, easy fix.
What I did, grab the device, run up the left stairwell, crouch down up there.
Oh yeah.
Head straight back. Elevator should now be behind you.
Yes.
And then make a left up here.
Do you really want to take
head straight. You'll see a little lobby room you'll pass through.
There are people.
Okay. Finder, okay. Killer.
Will they you don't. Don't kill anybody.
Will they just go past me? It seems like
this
they're going to look at me.
She was downstairs.
We'll find out. Oh, my God.
Yeah, they... God.
Fucking see anything
marshals.
Yet?
No, you don't.
Nope.
You don't see shit.
I think you're good. Does this have the Dishonored thing where you're always safe when you're looking around a corner, or does it not?
No, I don't remember.
I think the alien can kind of.
What do I do after this? I go left?
Yeah,
shit. Left down here, I think.
I think left down here.
Yeah.
No, maybe? What
I
is
think
that?
I think that's a door you can actually open.
Yeah, the green one.
Oh, no. Oh, that's going to alert the alien. That's the worst part of that.
Is that active at this point? Is the
alien? No, I don't think. Yeah, I think we're good right now.
It shows up here if you take your time.
Oh, wow,
I'm not
really?
Going down there. No way.
It does.
Got your hack.
It kills those people.
We can go through there at least, right?
If.
Like hide.
Well,
that's safe.
Safe-ish.
Yeah.
You get some ammo.
Yeah. Guns do nothing for you in this game. There is an item that you can get.
Well, the flamethrower.
Not three quarters, about halfway through. That kind of it kind of gives you like one freebie with the alien, and then it's gonna come back, kind of thing.
All right, I can get a map here.
Oh yes.
Oh nice. All right, so check your map. Maybe it updated with an objective marker.
Right, let me go
it's in here.
Here.
Yeah. You want to go in here?
I'm gonna go save.
Good call.
What I loved. Also about this was the this characterization being entirely mechanical.
Right.
Like she's an engineer. Oh. She doesn't like to kill. Like she doesn't get into it. She's not like yeah baby.
Right.
She fixes things. There's kind of like a you know an in universe like it's like I don't necessarily know exactly what she's doing as the player, but she knows what she's doing. She's doing the mechanical stuff basically. Which I really liked.
Well, I mean, basically just they wanted a way to. Tell a story about Ripley without like just remaking Alien, which wouldn't work. All the the ship's too small and
there's a whole bunch of
Reasons why you couldn't do it, but so you know I think the conceit about it being her daughter is kind of forced, but like it doesn't bother me at all.
Yeah.
Like,
does that
also,
come
if you watch horror
the...
films, you get over forced narrative consent.
Yeah, totally. You sure totally. Can.
Because that's kind of the name of the game. Because like the actual like reason things are happening is less interesting than what happens.
Than totally. What's actually going on, yeah.
The thing I like Andrew J. Plant just mentioned in the chat, I like this thing where you're coming into the middle of a different horror story that these NPCs have been living for weeks
true.
Or
yes. True.
Like, I would play the Marshall DLC for this. That's like, they first arrive and things haven't gone to shit yet. And it's just like slow build tension as they're trying to do their jobs until the alien arrives.
The DLC for this was pretty awesome.
Yeah,
what was it?
There's one that actually does take place during Alien.
Oh, really?
Board the Nostromo, I believe. Yeah, it's really short. It's like 20 minutes long.
It's a quickie, yeah.
I don't know if I played this. Is that the only story one? There might have been two story
There
DLC.
Were some like challenge mode ones that I
yeah,
actually...
Yeah, I didn't do any of that stuff.
I actually really liked those.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not saying it's not good, I didn't mess with any of it.
Yeah, I mean like...
Oh, God. Oh, boy. Hey, buddy. You didn't... That ain't a good look.
He's been dead for a while. Hi, Joel.
Joel's here.
Just saying hi to Joel from off camera.
You make flashbangs now, that seems useful. Not so much?
I don't think I ever used the gun. I think I definitely used that flamethrower.
How to get to the...
Oh, I used the gun on the androids. We're not there yet, though.
No, I'm trying to remember how to bring up the...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The radial menu. Shoot. It's gotta be, oh, here we go. Flashbang. I like this interface.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
I mean, like, the UI in this game, generally speaking, is pretty...
It's super
pretty
good.
Baller.
Yeah. Nice 1977-looking technology. Although
I mean,
in space.
They just nail the Ridley
the entire,
Scott
like,
aesthetic.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good.
Just...
You just
entirely.
Kind of believe that this is a place. And that's
totally
amazing, and one of the best things that video games can do.
Yeah, or if you know you have watched that film as much as we probably have, like it brings that to life in a way that is just
special.
Yeah, it's just like so fanboyish.
Yes.
Fangirlish is
fangirlish.
Thank you. Yes.
Fan gender neutral.
Fan non-binary.
Fan inclusive.
Yes. Yes.
By fan
all fans. All fans.
Stay focused.
She's having a bad day, but she's keeping her shit together, and I like that about her. She's
is.
Not. She doesn't have to be like Rambo woman. I love the Rambo woman thing.
That's
Don't get me
right.
wrong. Love that. But it's also cool to be like she's a nerdy woman who's just smart and cool-headed,
right.
and she's just getting through it because of it.
Totally.
You know.
Well, that was also what was interesting about Ripley, especially in the first film, is that she, I think people look back on Ripley as a character and think of aliens.
Right.
They do.
Ripley as a character in the first one is also like vulnerable and learning
yes.
and scared and
yes.
She's still very strong and like independent, but like she has an arc that is, you know, much different in Alien. Alien, she's just a badass.
Right.
Yes.
Big
yes.
in command.
We did the talk the other day about the comparison with Terminator and Terminator
yes.
2. And like, Sarah Connor has a very similar arc from like vulnerable, regular person, but still independent and still at the end of the
and
day
smart.
Able to take care of herself.
Like, has
smart.
Their shit together.
Exactly.
Yeah.
To like, oh, you're like a strapped badass.
Yeah.
You're like ready to go. I think the interesting difference there is that they play in Terminator 2 Sarah Connor's like apocalyptic, almost nihilism to like, to almost to be like, oh, this is the thing she has to confront. And
yeah.
I guess maybe that's not true. Because in Aliens, I think maybe the stuff with Newt is actually built around that too, of like, oh, Ripley has to have this like maternal, has to also have this maternal instinct, which is like then mirrored with the alien queen, right? Like, so there is this like tension in both of those series of these women characters going from vulnerable, like young, what's this? Like, I don't know how to pronounce this word. Ingenue.
Yeah, yeah.
To like badass, but is that so badass that it erases their quote unquote traditional femininity? And obviously, there were dudes involved directing these films.
Yeah, yeah, for
right.
sure.
But
for
that
sure.
it's worth thinking about those specific relationships with the maternal instinct and all
yes.
of that stuff.
I actually think, so Ben Kuchera and I, when I was at Polygon, actually did a little letter series about
this.
Which one was better, you know, alien versus aliens. Of course I argued for the aliens.
Of course.
And I actually said that the whole maternal portion of aliens was something of a weakness, for me at least. Yeah. It's kind of like, can a woman not be human without being a mother kind of thing? It's one of those, you know, obviously I don't like have a problem.
You're not like
with
dissing
Ripley
moms.
Being a mom.
Right.
I love moms.
Right.
I would like to be one day.
Totally.
Just making it like a requirement.
Exactly, making it a requirement. Oh, to be a home
that
woman.
That essential to being.
Exactly. Yes. That I'm like, you could be a lady without that.
Totally.
And, you know. Where do you two stand on Alien 3? That's the real question.
Okay, so one thing I've never done, and actually makes me like mildly upset to admit it, is like I've never watched the full-on director's cut of 3. If you're unfamiliar with 3, like 3 has this really weird history. It's David Fincher's first Hollywood production after he did music videos.
Yeah.
The version that he shot is not the version that he wanted to be in theaters. A lot of that footage was lost. It was edited to hell. Like the story about like the cult in there was like wildly changed from what he wanted to be in it. Like there's a version of Aliens 3 that sounds pretty interesting and where you get over the fact that they kill Hicks and Newt immediately. Like these characters that you would course want to see in a third film are gone. I think it's an interesting film, and especially if you like or are interested in David Fincher as a director, it's a fascinating movie.
Sure.
But that's a different thing than like, this thing is good in the way that it's a thing I want to tune off, like deep dig into, like really sit down and just watch and consume.
The fourth film, Alien Resurrection, is written by Joss Whedon.
Right.
I actually kind of enjoy that movie. Not gonna
lie. Does have sex with the alien.
She does have sex with the alien.
There's,
don't try to hide it.
The movie doesn't.
It's a dumb movie. It is a dumb.
The aliens.
Not
swim.
Good movie. But
that does happen.
But it's fun. It's ridiculous. It's all over the place.
It is.
Yeah, as long as you accept, like, basically that Alien and Aliens are, like, the only good movies in the series.
I think there's merit to 3.
There's merit to a lot of
different
ones.
There's merit to 3.
Like,
To Prometheus.
There's a lot of things I love about Prometheus.
Yes, me too.
Don't
me too.
Love
me too.
The last third of the movie.
All right, here's the thing. Did you ever watch the promotional, like, fake TED Talk?
Yes.
Oh, it's so good.
It's so fucking good. It's, like, doubly good because, one, it's just good. It's just great character work by guy. The thing we're talking about is for the promotion for Prometheus, they did a fake TED Talk with Guy Pearce.
Fassbender, or Guy Pearce,
Well, they did the Fassbender stuff, too, that was just, like, him as the android.
That was more
like
extra. That was exactly. That was sort of attached.
The thing I'm talking about is Guy Pearce as a young Peter Whalen, giving a TED talk about how he's gonna defeat.
Basically, like Ian
Malcolm at
Elon Musk. Yeah.
Elon Musk. Elon Musk.
Other famous.
Ian Musk.
Right.
Elon Musk. I was getting there.
I said Ian Malcolm from
Jurassic Park. All right. So I'm not alone.
You know what? Okay. Life is gonna find a way.
It is gonna find a way.
So it's alright.
But yeah, Elon Musk style, like all style, no substance. Like here is the. I'm gonna prove that technology is gonna save us all. And it's just great character work on Guy Pearce, and it makes me wish we'd gotten young Peter Whalen in Prometheus. And two, it's like this almost weird critique of TED Talks.
Totally.
Yeah.
It's amazing. And then, I think Prometheus had some really great stuff. I think the stuff on the show.
It has a really good trailer.
Really great trailer.
Good God, go back and watch that original trailer, and man, I was so excited for that movie.
It does.
Some really great characters.
I've been thinking a lot lately about, like, not just the value of a good trailer, but, like, you know, I think partially this is because we've been doing so much work.
Promo stuff.
Promo stuff. For real. Like, and seeing the difference between what, like, a... It's, like, a thing that you have to build for a company like this, is, like, transparency mode, is a reel that you show to advertisers. If you go to someone, for instance, Carl's Jr., and you say, like, oh, hey, we want to do this thing. We have a great documentary series. We have a great, you know, live event that we want to do, but it costs money, and we have to pay all these people who are involved to make it. We would love to be able to say, oh, presented by so-and-so, we're going to do this thing. To sell them on, like, to show them quickly what your projects look like and who you are, you could put together a reel that you show to them, like a little 3-minute long thing. And so I've seen a billion versions of that thing for the last couple of weeks to make sure that it doesn't misrepresent us, right?
Of course.
Because, like, it would be really easy to go to them and be like, oh, don't worry, it's perfect. Like, it's exactly the thing you want. And, like, no, I want it to be honest to what we have, et cetera.
Yeah.
And so seeing the different versions of that have given me a real appreciation for the ability to cut a 90-second or 60-second or 30-second trailer that, like, is in and of itself a valuable art object.
Yes.
That, like,
yes,
the trailer for Prometheus is worth liking separate from whatever you like or dislike about Prometheus.
Yeah.
Which is cool.
Yeah, no, it is very cool. I really love parts of that movie.
And, understandably. And then other parts are less good.
Other parts are just, why?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
And so here, things are flashing.
Idris Elba in that movie, though.
He's great.
I would watch 10 movies about that character. That
I just
guy.
Wrote.
That guy.
So I'm in the process of cataloging any games we may have missed. I want to see what our total count is right now.
Okay.
And I was trying to rate Virtua Racing, because we did that during the Run Button segment yesterday, which was yesterday.
Oh God, it was.
Or was that 2 days ago?
Wasn't 6 weeks ago.
It was Saturday.
That was yesterday.
For us, yeah.
Oh, I guess it's Monday.
It's Monday now, but it was yesterday.
Yeah, the wake cycle.
Cycle. And I wrote Virtua Elba instead of Virtual Racing. Idris Elba.
Good.
I'm gonna go through this list actually while you're exploring real quick and see if we're missing something.
I don't know where this power is that I have to turn on.
I don't know either. Just keep wandering.
Okay.
Spelunky.
Yep.
Owlboy.
Yep.
Owlboy.
Owlboy. Minecraft, which didn't work at first, but we wrapped back around and got it. For Honor, Choo Choo Rocket, Who Wants to Beat Up a Millionaire?
Oh, wow.
Remember that? Days ago.
Several.
Gears of War 4 with Desus and Mero. I'm going to add that here.
They were great.
Titanfall 2. Mm-hmm. Streets of Rage 2.
Oh, yeah, I played that.
Street Fighter 5. Oh, there's one missing here, which is Shinobi 2. Because that Just Blaze came through.
Revenge of Shinobi.
Sorry.
That's not two, right? That's three.
I know, because Shinobi 3 is just called Shinobi 3, and he rides a horse.
Oh, okay.
What's on the other side of the room in that area?
Well, it says low power, which means I must have missed a power thing that I have.
You get through over here? Yeah.
Drawful 2 with Justin McElroy.
We did this.
We had two Justins that day.
Yeah.
JoJo's, Dragon Ball Z Universe 2.
Actually, that was with Griffin.
All right, why did I say Justin? I meant Griffin. Sorry, you're right.
Wow. Sorry.
It's late.
It's super late.
Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4.
Yes, I did see that.
Danica's supposed to be asleep.
Go to bed. Tell Danica to go to bed.
Go to bed because you have
to. Hey, can you tab over and see where this power thing is?
Yeah, what do you need? What are you looking for?
I need to find power.
Specific objective? Because I can search for it.
Look for data cell.
Data cell.
And then I found the data cell.
Okay, you got
that.
I need
to know where the power is.
So you're at disable security lockdown?
Yes.
Man, the sound.
So what are you looking for
specifically?
Power cell? Power?
There's low power to a computer monitor. So I think I need to turn the power on. I don't know where the power thing is.
I don't remember ever being it being super annoying to, like, power things on. Maybe it's close.
Why, I think so. I'd like to see, like,
let me see, is that the thing you're looking for?
Yes.
Low
yes.
power. Is there not, like, a wire you could follow or some shit?
No. I've just been wandering around looking for a power thing that I gotta go.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Those things.
Tech support. Find it. Just tell me your exact. Can you hit pause or bring up an objective or something? No.
I guess I didn't. I guess I didn't check my.
There's your circle. There's a circle right there.
Well, that's where I have to go to.
Right.
But I have to get through.
So you can't do that until you do the computer.
No, I can't get through there yet.
All right. Do any of those represent power things? Is there a legend? Activate the legend.
There is a legend.
Let's see the legend. Rewire system.
Weapon. Security access point. Point of interest.
No, I'm not seeing it. Is there a
save point? That's the terminal.
Item tool weapon, maybe? We need item tool weapon. Tech support right in there. Looks like there's item tool weapon in those two sort of areas on the right there. That might be what it is.
Okay.
Through that tech support area.
All right, I'm looking at this thing. Four bad people spot you, okay. Revolver and key card, you've done that. Flashbang blueprint, you got that.
I got that.
Yeah, I think you're actually safe from the alien here, but
the alien starts right after this. It's like literally right after this section.
It can come in that place where the four people were.
No, I think it comes when I get out of here.
Well, yes, definitely, like a scripted event, but I'm pretty sure I took way too long once and like it ate those people.
Oh, really?
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
I'm almost positive. God, there's gotta be something flashing.
Hold on.
You're in this place.
Hold on.
Yeah, you're here. Yeah, it's right in this corner, Patrick.
It's right in front
of
you.
There you go.
It's all right. We're really tired.
Slightly more obvious.
We're really tired.
Like, enter.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Is it time to go? Is it go time? Oh, it's go time.
Oh, yeah.
Please duck.
I called this one Frankie in my game.
Did you?
Frankie the Xenomorph, yeah.
Okay.
And somebody made like a burner account.
Nice.
To be Frankie the Xenomorph, troll me in chat, too.
Oh.
Baby. That's a tail. Good God.
I actually wish they do this twice early on. The first introduction to the alien is in a cutscene.
Yeah.
Right.
That is poorly rendered.
Yeah.
And it's clearly CG.
Right.
And in this one, control is taken away from you.
Right.
So I think they actually make a mistake in both those instances because it would have been much more satisfying to sit here and go like this, to like see the emergence of it.
And like know that you could fuck up.
That you could screw it up. And even if they find a way to like not let you screw it up,
right.
Control the environment in some way. By removing control, you know you can't die.
Right.
And that's like the...
Totally.
The whole tension. And maybe they focus tested it and they were like, people are idiots.
Right.
We can't do this.
Totally.
And that may make, you know, I'm saying this to someone that plays, you know, hundreds of horror games, and I'm not the average person. So I'm gonna go ahead
and
get in here. One of my favorite ways for the game to kill you is to open one of those and it's hiding in the open.
Yes.
Opens and then just grabs your face and just eats you.
Yep.
Brutal.
Yep, it's pretty bad.
It rarely happens, because it's not often that the creature is actually still in the shaft while you're there.
Yeah.
But when it does happen, it's so good.
Freaky. And you don't have your tracker yet either.
No. All right, so we got the security locked down.
Oh my.
But don't worry. I've got this gun.
Great. It's gonna help a lot.
So I feel pretty confident that I'm gonna be able to make it up the stairs. So I'm gonna run.
Yay.
I love this way of doing an unlock system.
Oh, it's so good.
Like, I really hate lockpicking in games, but like...
This one was great.
This is pretty good.
The times where you know the alien is close.
Yeah, it's really...
Totally. You're doing this.
So stressful.
It is like...
That sounds really good.
Oh,
especially if you fuck up like that.
Yep.
Yeah.
Did you just say palm sweaty?
Yep.
Mom's spaghetti?
Good. Mom's spaghetti right there.
Hey, go find a Waypoint Easter egg.
Yeah.
Find Mom's spaghetti in the article.
There it is.
Yeah, it exists.
It's there. Oh, you know what? It's probably this that I was thinking of.
Yeah,
that's
what I thought.
It definitely eats those.
This is the same place. It's just
the same place.
Just right.
That's right. Sigson. I do really love, actually, the sort of little side stories in this game as well. Even though they're largely audio logs. The picture painted of a depressed, like, crappy mining colony, like, things are just going wrong, is actually pretty awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's pretty good.
Yeah, I think what's a bummer about the human story in this game is that the one that it suggests is a lot more interesting than the one it tells.
Yeah, yeah.
So like in the audio logs, like you, the way it paints what happened in this ship as shit, is they started to learn there was a creature systematically just hunting them throughout, like it makes the place seem wild.
Yeah.
But that just doesn't come across very well.
Right.
What you play. Like, they give you a revolver and you have to...
Right. Not necessarily the best.
There's no need for a revolver.
I don't know where it is. I'm just gonna hope.
That's the thing. Your ass is just, like, flipping in the breeze here. And you gotta do this. This is the first time they do this to you, actually. Because it could be right behind you.
And you can die in this, because
yes,
I have.
You can.
Nice.
You can super die in this. I think now you're safe. For a minute.
I hope so.
Oh, God.
I mean, all these achievements, it's like, that's right, because I played it on PS4.
Oh, yeah, same.
And then I did the DLC on PC.
Oh, okay. God, this game is... I really like it. Mm-hmm. Really like this game.
I don't know how they would have done, like, the ending sucks. Not because it goes on forever, but because, spoiler, this game came out 2 years ago, so
yeah.
Whatever.
Yep.
They essentially kill her at the end, and then, of course, do the, she's still alive.
But maybe, yeah, it's, you know.
Which isn't really the problem as much as, like, if they were gonna pick up that thread.
Yeah. Right.
Well, one, if you're gonna do that, and then, like, so you're gonna do the evolution from alien to aliens, that's not the game I wanna play.
Yeah, same.
I don't. Like, I want another survival game. It wouldn't be interesting to actually try and dodge the alien a second time.
Yeah. Totally.
Hello, my name's Ripley, Amanda Ripley.
These
Here's
are
your first Android.
That's a really shit. Creepy thing.
Someone will be with you shortly.
Oh, its mouth doesn't move, huh?
No wonder Seekson is losing the
tail. Oh, what's up with its neck?
They're just weird rubber things.
Yep. And one of the more interesting stages of the game is actually a factory of those.
Yeah.
Those horrible things.
And they're all just messed up, and you're not sure which ones are going to talk to you or walk at you.
Yep.
Beating them with a wrench is cool, I guess.
And when they kill you, when they come for you, they're like, please calm down. Please calm down as they're, like, killing you. As they're, like, wrenching the life from your body.
I actually think that's going to happen here.
Yes. Sorry, did I just ruin it for you?
Oh, nah, it's fine.
It's fine. It's fine.
Did you ever try to light one on fire?
Yes.
Oh, that sounds like it's going to go bad.
Yeah, they do. I've tried to Molotov a couple of them, and they're just...
I thought I was fine. Whatever. I was like, ow, threw a, you know, he's on fire, I'm fine.
Not so much.
I know he's still coming at me.
He'll kill you with his fire.
I forget what they call them.
Joe? Something Joe.
Yeah, yeah.
Helper
Normal
Joe.
Joe. Helper Joe.
Something like that.
Something Joe. Average Joe?
Average Joe's, something like that.
It's on the poster. I'm sure we'll
see
a poster.
I'm sure we'll find one.
Immortan Joe?
That's it, Immortan Joe.
It's a little different. That model didn't sell.
Titanfall 2. He was with Sean Slayton.
I need to get into comms control. It's urgent.
Drew McCoy. I couldn't remember Sean Slayton's name the other day.
Don't you realize what's going on?
Apollo has the situation in hand.
Thanks, Apollo.
Not the way it bends at its neck.
It's so good.
That's not how skin works.
But, like, if you imagine that it was flat for a long time, and someone had to say, like, oh, that doesn't look good. That looks worse.
Yeah.
Like, in the universe, in the fiction.
Somebody did.
Someone's like, oh, that doesn't look, that looks worse. We should give them some flaps. Some neck flaps.
And they even... Really, really, another really cool part about this is that this is Seekson Corporation, which is like a shitty version of Weyland-Yutani, which is the, you know, the corporation in the movies. Yeah, exactly. So, like, everything's just a little bit shittier here, and I love that there's, like, that little subtle nudge towards, oh, here, we're doing a corporate dystopia story, so let's throw that in.
Yep.
Good. God, the fan.
Here it is, baby.
Some kind of tracker.
Here it is.
Oh,
please.
Yeah.
It's been modified.
All the time.
Oh, that fan is good, and the shadow
on
the
fan
floor.
Is so good.
I'm not sure I've played a game with lighting nearly as good as this game still is.
Yeah.
For some reason. also. Oh, oh God.
Oh. No, we're good.
No, no problem.
We're good, homie. You can go.
Thanks, Joe.
Really subtle thing this game does that, oh God, it's so good. Tons of little touches. So when you hold up the motion tracker, it blurs.
Yeah.
So yes, you get to know where things are in the environment, whether it's these average Joes or the Xenomorph, but you lose that perspective.
Right.
And it's just, ah, it's such really a good little touch.
It's really good.
Some very smart people working on
it. It's one of those things that, you know, is possible with like budgets and like
right.
tons of like lighting like this. It's not like, you know, folks work on Amnesia or other like indie horror games couldn't do this if they were given the resources.
Yeah.
They just don't have that.
Right. We're on Sevastopol stage.
I'm gonna go back to counting through these. I wanna know if I missed
something. Oh yeah, right. Keep going.
Yeah.
We're good. And at me, or actually literally just get at me, tweet at me if when I'm done this list I forgot something, please. So, I'm gonna go from the top real quick. Spelunky, Owlboy, Minecraft, For Honor, Choo Choo Rocket, Who Wants to Beat Up a Millionaire, Gears of War 4, Titanfall 2, Streets of Rage 2, Street Fighter 5, Drawful 2, JoJo's, Dragon Ball Xenoverse, I almost said Mario Ultimate Ninja Storm, Naruto.
No, give it 2 years and that game's
Mario
gonna exist.
Mario Ultimate Ninja Storm, please send me that fan art.
Good.
Mr. Bones, The Suffering,
yep.
Monkey Island, Dragon Quest Builders, Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze, Cruisin' USA, Superman 64, Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective, Super Smash Brothers, Battle Chef Brigade, Overcooked, Doom, Knuckles Chaotix, Star Wars Arcade, Sonic Mega Mix, CNC Make My Music Video,
good.
Sewer Shark, Star Fox 64, Battleship Jenga, Destiny, Dark Souls 3, Pokkén, Long Live the Queen, Blaze Blue, Sonic All-Stars Racing, Dishonored, Bad Mojo Redux, Harvester, Carrier, Alien
Isolation. I just delete Harvest. Yeah. That game might not count.
I know. The universe.
Alien Isolation, Bomberman Act Zero, Tony Hawk Ride, Outlaw Golf, Far Cry 2, Dragon's Dogma, Scrabble Chess, Rocket League, GoldenEye, Witch Ball, Breakup Squad, Duck Game, Mafia 3. I always sound like the Pokemon song.
Yeah.
A little bit.
A little
Duck
rhythm.
Game, Mafia 3.
Right, yeah. Weeping Bell. Signal from Tolvo, Perfect Dark, Kitchen, VR, the VR demo.
Yes.
Thumper, Res Infinite, Dungeon World, Virtual Racing, back from the day before. Revenge of Shinobi, Sonic CD, and that's where I'm at. I might be missing a couple.
What are we at?
Do you want to really know?
Yeah.
67.
So five away.
Five
away. I know what two of them might be.
Good.
That's not a lot, though. So 9 hours, 36 minutes. Only five new challengers.
Yeah.
You said GoldenEye, right?
I did say GoldenEye.
This is the bathroom.
Let me activate the shower.
I could probably go for a shower.
Let me activate the real shower.
Yeah, actually. God, and all these rooms.
We didn't play Overwatch. I already listed. I did list Far Cry 2. I did say Street Fighter 5. I did not say not Knack.
What if that was game 72?
Nope. It'd be a shame to end a beautiful thing like Waypoint because of Knack.
Oh, don't. Oh no, we got Knacked.
Oh. Hot food.
Don't worry, we'll play that game one day. It may not be this.
They almost got us. They played Job Simulator on the stream. That counts.
Oh.
CL made it clear that even if we weren't playing it, if it was on the stream, that counts.
Do we know how many other VR games they played while we were doing that 3-hour thing? We might have already hit 72.
It has to happen.
No.
It has to happen on the stream, though.
Oh, okay.
That's the thing. Not just all near right. the stream. I did say Tony Hawk Ride.
Smoke bombs are good.
We did not play Yoshi's Island. Are smoke bombs good in this?
So are the noisemakers.
Yeah, I use the noisemakers a ton. Or flares.
Yeah. Look at that comfy room. It's got the padding on the walls. It's
yeah, Jenga counts. I said Jenga.
Smoke bomb. That's a smoke
bomb.
Yeah,
it is.
Said Thumper. We're good. Boat party doesn't count. That looks good. That's a good smoke.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't say chess, did I?
Chess.
I did say chess.
You chess played chess this morning. That was this morning.
That was this morning. Ah. Yeah, we count Jenga and Battleship. We totally do. Good. Was VR Worlds on stream? Did they play VR
Worlds? I know
they were
playing it. I didn't know it was on stream.
They might have, but Job Simulator is in. No, that's the demo disc.
Oh.
No, I had Job Simulator too.
You had that in there.
No, but is VR Worlds the demo disc, or is the demo disc different than
that's
VR
different
Worlds?
That's different than VR Worlds.
Oh. I've got that PSVR. Where am I going?
Hold on. You're trying to get to the communications tower, I think? Yeah.
All right, VR Worlds. Am I going down? I'm gonna add VR Worlds. That's one game. Each of those doesn't count as a game, otherwise
yeah,
I'm like, done.
Yeah,
I don't know what they did. Three games left.
Oh boy.
Let me just really focus on returning to old games we don't want to go over.
Oh, no. Okay, I came up here.
Yeah, that's where you learned craft. The art of crafting.
Okay, all right, so I'm going.
Shit.
I get distracted by picking things up and trying
Onimusha to Onimusha Blade Warriors.
Oh, that's...
Wait, what?
Shit. Yeah, that's 70?
Oh, God, 70? Are we at 72?
We're at 70. Joel,
off screen.
Fuck. Got it.
Oh man, Onimusha Blade Warrior.
Uh huh.
God.
Yeah, I remember playing as that zombie.
Do you remember Superman 64?
Dude, if there was a way that I could pick up where we were,
I know. Me too.
I would play it again.
Me too.
But I don't know that I can.
Get there again.
I mean, I could. Mm. I don't know if I'm willing.
Yeah.
Because I made it an hour into that game.
Yeah.
But goddamn that. I don't even know what I did wrong. That's like what makes me like the most upset about it is that I ran into that room.
I know.
Those robots.
I know.
That lady was really upset at me.
She was so mad.
But they were like, five enemies in there.
I said Sonic Mega Mix. I'm watching the chat. I haven't seen anything else that we haven't already said.
Oh God, they're pissed. Average Joe is pissed. He's gonna kill somebody, probably.
Listen to
Maybe?
Me. We've got to reestablish long-range communications.
Oh, no.
You're becoming hysterical.
Oh no.
Get back! I'm warning you.
Tut,
tut.
Oh,
tut, tut is really good.
Oh wow. Oh, God.
Hey, Average Joe, not so average.
I believe I got all the Sonics, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh.
I think he's a little bit dead. Good day, thank you.
Like, what I will give this game credit for is the Average Joes are a really creepy secondary enemy.
Yeah.
And that's
they
like,
figured out, like, we can't be humans. Humans can't be the thing that you're doing.
Well, the problem they do make is that humans are a thing.
Right, but, like, that can't be the main secondary enemy, right?
Well, it's more that you think with a game in which the xenomorph is the main...
Working Joe.
Just it.
Working Joe is what they're called.
Working Joe.
Thank you, Chad.
They found another, in some ways, creepier enemy because you don't know what the Working Joes are going to do.
Yeah, they're really terrifying and unpredictable. And they have eyes. That's terrifying.
Yeah.
Xenomorph doesn't have eyes. So yeah, you gotta stealth your way around certain sections. I mean, you have to stealth your way around a lot of this game, but also mechanically, like in terms of the mechanical...
Mechanically, you have to mechanic
your
way around this game.
I'm trying to evoke the actual sort of like chunky machinery itself, but I'm failing. So chunky machinery, you have to watch out for lights.
Oh, damn. So what, am I gonna try and hit him with a,
There's no Mafia 3 easy button.
Oh, I have a revolver.
Oh yeah, that's all.
But it will
alert. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, fucking calm down. Oh my God.
That was terrifying.
Oh Okay.
I think you gotta shoot that guy.
Okay,
shoot
hold
that
on.
Guy, shoot that guy, shoot that guy.
Hold right. on.
Or will that
all over? Let me just walk over here and shoot that guy in the face.
Don't do that, no.
He's oh my, bleeding from his eyes. He's bleeding from his eyes. Oh, he looked like he was
10 seconds. What was that? How much ammo do you
have? Yeah, don't three worry. There's shots. Another one coming for me.
You only have three shots left.
Oh, don't touch me.
Oh.
Oh, Jesus.
This is terrifying.
Oh, Jesus. Touch.
Okay, hold on, hold on. Reload, reload, reload.
You got this.
Let's be cool.
Why did you only load one round? Does you have to round, load each round individually?
Yes.
Oh, of course you do.
This game.
This game.
Oh, that might be it.
Oh, that might be it.
Oh, my God.
That might be it.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. No, you
jam it, jam it, jam it. Oh, my God. Really?
Damn it.
You did not load that bullet.
Is there another one out there? Oh, that's a that's security a camera.
That's a bad thing. That's a door.
That's.
Oh! Ho, ho, ho.
Nice work.
Holy.
So that's what makes shit. Those creatures so,
or like
androids yeah. just never amazing.
Stop. That's yeah. really good.
Yes. And then once you get access to like better weapons, like the flamethrower, you think like, oh, I got this.
No.
No.
And then also you run out of ammo, so then you just have to try and whack them with right. your wrench.
But they're clearly just way better at you yep. at melee range.
Oh, definitely. And they have that creepy milky blood too, which is a great touch.
My friend Allie in the chat from Friends of the Table just says, he strangle you?
Yeah.
Yeah, he strangle you. It's true.
Fortunately.
Pretty much. God, this game is awesome.
Oh man, that was intense.
It's awesome. It's just too long.
We did not play Kentucky Route Zero. I like Kentucky Route Zero.
Oh,
but
it's a good game.
Yeah, I haven't played the.
I haven't played it since the first
the new
episode.
One.
I have. So the first.
So behind.
So I lost my chapter 3 save, my post chapter 3 save. So I need to replay chapter.
Oh wait,
three.
This stuff's not cloud saves.
No.
Oh man. Then I am fucked. Uh-huh.
Start over, dude. We never played with the boat PC. That happened today too. They built a boat PC.
Boat PC. That's not a game though.
No, it's not. But that happened.
Did happen.
I don't think that they tried anything
look at these
on it.
Posters. Oh, I love it. God.
We didn't play Robot Golf ever, right?
I
didn't. Oh, the.
You guys might
no, I didn't.
100 Robot Golf? No, I did not. Wait, how was Outlaw Golf?
You don't want to talk about it. It wasn't Harvester bad, but it was close.
Okay. Oh, it's probably has a bunch of bad
oh, yeah.
types.
Like that? Okay. I hear you. Oh, good. An ID tag.
That makes sense.
Uh-huh.
I don't know why I'm surprised about that.
Me either.
Yeah, unfortunately, revisiting the 90s is uncomfortable sometimes.
Yeah. Last night when we were playing Harvester, I actually had a moment where I was like, should we stop this? Like,
well, I did.
I actually had a moment where it was like...
Yeah. When Pat did not pick up on what occurred, he was like, "No, go to the lodge." I'm like, "Man, I don't think you saw what I just saw on the screen."
Actually, and somebody actually asked me about that on Twitter. It was like, "Where's the line?"
That was the line.
Kind of, and it's like I think Harvester might have been the line,
right,
but it was worth
line.
Examining as an artifact of the.
Well, I mean,
it's
sold
itself.
On Steam, right?
Yes.
Like we didn't buy that off the internet. Like yes. that wasn't like, "Oh, it's a game that no one knows what that is anymore." Like.
Right.
Like, Harvester is a game you can literally
product
go
can
buy
try.
Right mm-hmm. now.
Yeah. So I think it was worth investing.
Doesn't mean like it's like excusable. Or
totally.
Like,
oh, absolutely.
But it's like, and also like it was, you know, produced by a company that like is, you know, they raised money on Kickstarter for System Shock. Like they chose that as a game. They
yeah.
thought it was interesting to bring back.
There's some strong mixed feelings.
No one about. No one knew what Harvester was until.
Until we.
They decided they wanted to put that on Steam and make that run on modern machines.
Totally.
Yeah.
But I think even though I have not gotten the all clear, it is.
I don't know what happened. We didn't get.
Send your communications
it's
2:35.
Yeah. So I think we're gonna production. I think we're gonna take a break.
We've had our alien encounter. We've been attacked by a worker.
Update this map.
Yeah.
I'm gonna save. And I think
Joel's gonna come on.
Yeah,
with me.
It's fine.
I think.
It doesn't matter.
All right.
So we're gonna take a break. We're gonna tag some people in. Some other games are gonna be played. Some people are gonna sleep. Some people are not gonna sleep.
Yep, that's right.
Even though you have a blanket, you are not gonna sleep.
I'm cozy, but I'm gonna sleep in like an hour.
Okay.
Austin and I are gonna go
try to catch up on some sleep.
I'm gonna go to my hotel. I'm gonna sleep for a little bit.
I'm gonna go to
check out, and then I'll be back here.
Screening room maybe, and sleep in the screening room.
Screening room. I'm like in the living room up there.
The screaming room.
Yeah, it is the screaming room.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Perfect place to sleep.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more from Waypoint's 72 hours and only 9 hours and 24 minutes are left.
Yes.
That clock makes sense now.
It does. I can look at you. Oh, yeah, that's how long we have left.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the late night segment here. Waypoint 72 games in 72 hours. Waypoint.vice.com is where you should go for all the wonderful things. I'm here, it's just me and Joel right now. Joel, we have 9 hours left. And this music is keeping me going right now because this is how I feel about life right now. You're gonna play some Destiny.
I think so. So we have a predicament, Twitch chat.
Oh no.
We have tallied our games, and we're at
70. We only have two games.
There's some variables here at play because you see there were some side games.
Yeah.
And the camera caught some other games, so we don't quite know what the parameters are. But we are kind of limited.
That's why we're going back to some old favorites. And so we've played like 1,500 hours of Destiny or something.
Yeah, we don't need to.
You didn't need to say that on camera, did I?
We don't. No. You can say that on camera.
Okay.
No. Blast me all you want. It's late. But we don't have to play Destiny. So if there's something else that you would like, we have Titanfall 2. I have not played yet.
Play Titanfall 2?
You. Do you have anything? You're dying?
I want to hang out with you, Joel.
Destiny, it is, it sounds like.
Let's chill.
Survey says, don't play Destiny. We're not going to play anything for 4 hours, don't worry.
Don't worry, friends.
We're better than that. Dark Joels could happen.
Oh, we could do that.
Yeah, Dark Joels could happen. We did make it to a bonfire.
Is it Dark Souls 3? Or one that you're playing?
I'm playing Dark Souls 3.
That's the one I know.
Yeah.
I can help you a little.
And you're more into Bloodborne, right?
Way more into Bloodborne. Yeah.
Why is that?
Okay. Well, Bloodborne, first of all, I feel was a little bit more accessible. It was my first ever Soulsborne game. I mean, I played a tiny bit of Demon's Souls, like way back when it first came out. And was like, none of this. Then I played Bloodborne. I played it with my colleague Phil Kohler over at Polygon. And I got so into it, like sort of doing a Let's Play thing with him, that I was just like, no, I need to play this game. And it rewards aggression. And it also has this weird horror aesthetic that's
it's
like
creepier,
super
right?
And it's just weird. It's
and
it's, so weird.
Doesn't it have, I've heard it has a lot more like kind of jump scary kind of things.
Yeah, it's just like creepy, weird Halloween stuff is going on in that game. So I really enjoyed Bloodborne. It made me mad, but I enjoyed it. you know, it's one of those. And then I played about 60 hours of Dark Souls 3. I was stuck on one boss for 15 in-game hours, not like real-life hours, but like 15 hours of in-game stuff. I was stuck. It was miserable. It was awful. I beat that boss. It was the Abyss Watchers, in case.
Wait, you were stuck on the Abyss Watchers?
15 hours of my life.
Are you serious? 15. So that's what we beat last night.
Wow. Well,
we had to.
We
had to use an ember. We had to use an ember, and someone from the chat was gonna hop in, but they, I guess they hopped into someone else's game. Yeah, so we got, you know, a shade of someone.
Okay.
And the shade did a lot of work, but we were there for the final whoop-de-swoop.
See, that's pretty cool.
And then we got into the catacombs.
I ripped through the catacombs and the next area and the next area.
You just, like, sprinted through.
In, like, 2 hours after that. Like, I went through a third of the game in, like, 2 hours after being 15 hours of just trying to level up to a point I could beat the Abyss Watch.
We made it to our first catacombs bonfire.
Okay.
But I did fall off that bridge where the ball follows you a lot. Aww. But it was really late, and it was good vibes with Austin and I. We were talking about, you know, we're talking about how we, like, first came up with the idea for what this whole should be.
That's good times. Awesome. That sounds like some good times. I've never played. Okay, that's not true. I've played Destiny like 3 times, and I haven't remembered what happened in any of those times.
All right, let's go.
Like, chat. Run around, shot some things, I think.
Xbox, Destiny?
So what I've heard is that the appeal of Destiny is that it's like a good ever game. That like the shooting just feels really good, that there's, you know, there's kind of always new content for it, so it's just always like, this feels good.
Did you ever play?
3 times and I don't remember anything.
Really?
I don't remember a thing. Wow. It was early, though. It was like early Destiny. So.
Yeah, so it was like year one. That's 2 years ago.
Year one. Destiny Year One.
700 hours.
Special. It's very special.
We can do Crucible. I'm getting a little fire team together.
You're gonna do a raid?
Yeah, my gamer tag.
I don't even know what that actually means.
My gamer tag is Reptar.
But I have an expert here with me.
Yeah, the thing with Destiny is there's always something to do in Destiny. It's that's good and bad.
Yeah. Oh, this looks very different.
Yeah, so there's a little Halloween celebration.
It's Halloween, Joel.
It is Halloween. It's officially
that?
Halloween.
It's actually Halloween right now.
This so happy Halloween. Celebrated. Happy Halloween, Twitch.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for
Thanks
being
for spending
here.
It with us.
Thanks for spending time with us, everybody in chat. Again, shout outs to chat for being so positive. It's such a warm, supportive
We're
atmosphere.
Not doing Vault of Glass. I'm sorry, I just had to interject that.
Oh, no Vault of Glass. Oh, boat party.
I did. I never got the Vault of Glass pistol.
Oh, Frankie the Reptar. That's cute. In case you didn't know, Frankie the Xenomorph was what I named my Xenomorph.
Really?
In Alien Isolation. And so,
I'm guessing Super Dodgy is coming in from chat.
So I'm in chat as Joel saying, hi. Happy Halloween with the cool Gears thing. For people who play Destiny but not MMOs, you should know most modern MMOs aren't as grindy as Destiny.
Well, they fixed, so Destiny, its first iteration, there were a lot of, like, resource, you know, there were a lot of, like, things that required you to do the same activity, and there was really no better way than running around, opening chests, gathering, like, resources, and they've slowly introduced into the economy of the game, like, ways to alternate ways to buy all the stuff you need to level up your guns, and they've been a lot more rewarding with giving you like package rewards and experience rewards, and you can do this activity to level up, or you could kind of do another one. Whereas it used to be like you just had to go in the raid
and do it.
And hope that RNGesus would bless you with some.
Did you say RNGesus?
RNGesus, yeah. The kind of Destiny Reddit.
I like that.
Jammer. All right, so I got some stuff to do.
So what I've done in Destiny is danced.
Yeah, I've got some sweet dances. Do you remember?
Remember that guy.
Do you remember the stanky leg?
Oh.
I've got something that's.
Whoa. Oh, those are some moves.
Yeah.
Oh.
This is as Atlanta as I can get.
Yeah.
For this PG-13 stream, you know.
Yep. It's very PG-13.
So we're.
Whoa, who's this?
I am bidden to grant you.
So this is Aeris. She's kind of.
Tiny box.
She's kind of a bummer. She's always a bummer. And so last Halloween, you know, your guide at the tower dressed up as Aeris. I wonder if he did it again this year. Let's go check in. He had an Aeris mask. Let's see if he's dressed up. No.
What did you find?
Yeah,
so you're trick-or-treating right now. That's
I'm trick-or-treating.
Super cute.
In Destiny.
I really wish if we could have added more games, I would have really wanted to play Costume Quest with you.
What is Costume Quest?
Chill game. It's a little tiny, sweet JRPG from Double Fine. It's a Double Fine game. It was their first, I think, smaller game. It was like sort of once they decided in 2010 or so to be like, we're going to make games that are not massive AAA games, basically. You're a kid at Halloween, and you do trick-or-treating, and you do battle with monsters. And it's fantastic. One of my favorite seasonal games. I also really love Brutal Legend for Halloween. I like Double Fine games for Halloween. It's just a thing.
Got a new Zalo.
But since we only have two games to go, and we have some stuff scheduled for tomorrow, couldn't
worry. We're in this with you, Twitch chat. We're not going to play anything for, like, four
Don't worry,
hours.
We'll switch this up.
Switch it up.
We'll switch this up.
But this tomorrow at noon, we've done 72 hours.
Yeah, we're in the 60s.
You essentially just sent Patrick to space.
Yeah.
With his keytar earlier.
That was.
I mean, a lot has happened. That.
My life.
So. A lot of people in the chat were asking, is that your normal accent? Since you've subdued to, you know, to interact with the rest of the world.
So I grew up honestly speaking that way. It's affected a little bit for sure. But like I do, you know, if I'm home, I grew up in Rhode Island. I grew up with a pretty strong Rhode Island accent, which is like a Boston accent, but a tiny bit more nasally. It's a little bit like this. And you know, you drop your as at the end of words a little bit. I was doing this, though. I was doing.
Yeah, like, you were doing the like the
Lorna.
Lorna from
Orange Is the New Black.
Orange Is the New Black.
Yeah, I was doing 100%. I was putting a little extra on it, for sure. But yes, generally that is my natural accent. It's a strong Rhode Island accent.
Let's see what the night.
Which I was like, in college, a bunch of my friends made fun of me for like how I said words. Like I said, I needed to go get some water once, and they were like, water.
Water.
And I was like. Fine, I'm gonna work on this. And so, now I feel proud again.
Long Island, they say water.
Water?
Water. I'm gonna get some water.
Water.
And then, yeah, you add it. You overdo the A in Boston, Rhode Island, and
water.
Delaware. Delaware gets a little weird.
Northeast, a lot of Northeast kind of that stuff going on there.
How did you feel about your first tabletop experience?
It was magic.
I was a I was supposed to play with you all,
But
it's like
you needed some sleep.
I did yesterday from 9 a.m. through last night.
No.
And then I woke up halfway through when we were supposed to play Rocket League.
That's right.
Because I fell asleep in the screening room.
Yeah.
And the person that was gonna wake me up fell asleep.
Oh no.
See. So Rocket League was the only segment that that people have been a little nasty on, so far. I got some people on Twitter that were saying, you know, how dare you attempt to play Rocket League? Like, aren't you guys supposed to be professionals? And it's like, we're playing.
Professional like we're playing. Writers and media people. We're not professional.
Yeah,
team.
We're playing soccer cars. You know, we're like flying through the air and
be chill,
hitting
man.
The ball. And Rocket League is like my, it's kind of like my like stress reliever game, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, I want to play something like Rocket League or Overwatch, because it's like, Destiny
fun.
Wants you to play for...
Wait, have we played Overwatch on stream already?
Have we played Overwatch on stream?
Because then that would be a thing we could play.
Check waypoint.zone.
All right, waypoint.zone. Friends, we're checking out, we're seeing if we can...
So send me, tell them if anyone wants to play, we're going to hop in Crucible. Nothing too sweaty. Tell them to send me a friend's request. I am Reptar. I'll show you my name.
I really love that your name is Reptar.
Reptar with a 4.
Were you a big Rugrats fan?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
And we're the same age, so sometimes it's lost on a little younger, but like, yeah. You know, Rugrats.
I love that show.
It was the shit.
It was really good.
Dr. Lupo.
No, there's no Overwatch on here.
That sucks. How do we not play Overwatch? We could be building turrets right now.
I just want you to know that we played Harvester, but not Overwatch.
Rick Rockman. Oh my god, we played, he was in our little trials team.
Oh, Rick Rockman.
Let's send you an invite.
I don't know. Probably wouldn't be the worst thing to play a game that we might want to play again later as well. So we could maybe burn a game, but it has to be real good.
I'll add him back.
Yeah, we do have a Minecraft server and you should check it out, my friends.
Oh, we haven't popped in that. We should pop into that.
We could do that.
Yep, see what that's up. Like, I saw a picture that Danica posted, but we might have some server issues. If you can't come in, Rick, just ping us in the Twitch chat. So I have to get kills wearing this Halloween mask. I'm dressed as an Ingram, which is what you pick up.
Yeah.
I have some cool masks from last year, which I'll pick up.
So were you covering games at all when this game first came out?
So this is my first, like, job within games.
With games?
And
wow.
And all of my vice trajectory has been super weird and accidental. We're gonna do the daily crucible. I'm the publisher for Thump, which is the electronic music channel here.
Yes.
And as Noisy confirmed earlier, one of the only two music sites in the world. And I was helping them when they were putting together last year what they wanted to do for gaming.
Sweet.
And, you know, I think I kind of said on stream a little bit last night, it's like I've always had games as a big part of my life, but pretty disconnected from like a comprehensive like understanding of what's going on in gaming. I didn't pay attention to E3, didn't, you know, I would mostly browse subreddits for the stuff that I like, and I would play a couple games, you know, every few months that like my friends and I would play together. And was super into it, and so I started looking at what they wanted to do within gaming, and I was like, hey, I like games.
Yeah.
And then in January of this year, they were like, hey, Joel, you like games? We're finally gonna pull the trigger on launching Vice Gaming, so you should run it. And I said, okay, so here we are.
So here we are.
Yeah. Oh, I don't want to turn off.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
I'm doing all right.
I thought someone added me as a friend.
I thought so too.
Shoot me a message. Shoot me a message instead of the friend thing, because
yeah, there we go.
That'll be easier, and I can add you.
So why I was asking was, I'll tell you this, as somebody who's in the press at the time, we could not publish enough Destiny stories because they did real well.
Oh, it was like Pokemon Go, right?
It was a little bit like that for a while, and it was like,
we need that Destiny traffic.
Early Destiny that wasn't quite as robust. A lot of us in the press, I'll just say that, were kind of like, I don't get it, but we got to keep writing about this game.
You didn't get, I mean, wasn't it a pretty big deal to be like the next Bungie game? With the kind of, you know, the legacy that Bungie has.
With
and then
the
they also
Paul
announced
the McCartney song and all the
stuff. And the 10-year plan.
Yeah,
you know,
the
a 10-year game. I could totally see that though. You know, we see trends, especially traffic trends and Google trends,
sure.
Within all of our verticals, and sometimes it's like, hey, if you write about pizza today, it's gonna crush it.
It's gonna do well. Which is not to say that, obviously, you don't plan your content strategy only around the clicks. It's just funny sometimes what things trend. And, like, you know, how to approach that is always an interesting question.
I mean, Pokemon Go was that thing. I mean, Pokemon Go for 3 weeks was the number one app search term. I played it a lot. Austin and I, when he first started here. There we go. What's up, Cool Drew?
Cool Drew. Welcome, Cool Drew.
But again, kind of ran out of things to do in that.
Yeah.
I believe. Did you play it at all?
Oh God, I did, and it was like an excuse to walk the dog again.
That was what was fun about it.
Yeah.
I met I live in Clinton Hill, and I've lived there for 2 years, and I met more neighbors in the first 4 days Pokemon Go came out than I have the entire time I've lived there.
I totally believe that. Bushwick was crawling with Pokemon Go.
Oh yeah, and did you go to the park in Chinatown?
No.
Oh my God, it was awesome.
I didn't do that.
It's normally like a card game park, but it was taken over by young people. Myself included, tons of lures, and Pikachus for days.
Nice. Somebody was trying to post your loadout, but I think links are not allowed in chat right now. So I hear you.
My loadout?
I think links are just generally discouraged in all.
Yeah, what's up with that, Nightbot?
I don't know. Nightbot's doing some stuff.
Nightbot, you know, whatever Nightbot wants to do with the chat.
Sun and Moon hype. No one. You excited for the new Pokemon? Proper Pokemon?
Yeah, so I haven't played a proper Pokemon game. A proper Pokemon game. I'm saying I'm not considering, you know, Pokemon Go a proper game. Since Game Boy Color, when I was in eighth grade. Because in the South, middle school is 6th, 7th, and 8th. That is the last proper Pokemon game that I played. And Austin was getting me hype the other day. What's the deal with it?
It just looks good and it's, you know, set in a brand new area and they're doing all this Alola. Could be wrong.
Nice shot.
There's all new creatures and there's all these Alola versions of like existing creatures. So, and of course the starters are all cute. And I don't care. Popplio's adorable. He looks a lot like my dog.
And what's it gonna come out on?
The Nintendo 3DS. Are you excited for the Switch?
I am excited for the Switch. I did not buy the Wii U. I had a Wii and loved it.
Wii U is an underrated system. There's some great games on it.
What's up, Cedar Ben? We'll get you in here in a second.
It's Alola. It's basically Hawaii, but also has snowy mountains. Of course.
I know I'm spamming the shotgun, but you know.
Yeah, it's all right.
We're an hour 60 something.
Yeah, we sure are. Danielle, did you see Popplio's final Evo yet? Yes, and it's beautiful. Also, we have somebody from Hawaii in chat. Thanks for being here, friends.
What do they think about Alola Pokemon?
Hey, how you feeling about Alola Pokemon, friends?
Well, more so the person from Hawaii.
Yeah. Friend from Hawaii. Jira Park, how you feeling about it? It snows on one mountain in Hawaii, they say. Well, that's cool.
So while you were playing Alien
Isolation. Great.
We had a cut finger on set. I had to break out the first aid kit. I know you would have hopped up in
the. I would have hopped all on that.
I know you would have been there. I took care of it.
Nice work.
Yep.
Did you do your BSI? Your scene safety?
Yeah. I didn't really have to get in there with the two barrier rules.
All right, good.
Yeah.
Good.
The ABCs were clear, you know.
ABCs were clear. I'm happy about that. Yeah. What we were talking about. Actually, we should talk about this because it's appropriate.
Yeah, let's. That's actually if we ever are like, what's something we should, you know.
Yeah.
Kill some time with. I think the fact that both of us work on ambulances
medical training
is it's pretty unique. I haven't really met. Don't shoot me. I'm on your team. I haven't really met any other EMTs.
Really? Like,
I mean, obviously when I work with EMTs, sure. But just since I stopped doing it, I don't think I've met anyone.
Well, you met me.
Met you? So you're a volunteer.
Yeah, I'm a volunteer EMT.
So unpaid.
Totally unpaid.
Just
out of the goodness of my heart.
You're an amazing person, Danielle.
Thank you. I do it because you want to know the real reason. I started my career in the nonprofit world. I worked at the ACLU for years, and I love doing this. Like, I love streaming, I love writing about games, I love covering games. It feels good, it is wonderful, I feel honored to do it. But I do have that like twinge of like, I gotta do my feel good stuff too. I gotta do my little, you know, volunteering gig or my little, you know, I once had that as sort of part of my job, the sort of feel good, do goodery kind of stuff. So I like volunteering. It feels good to me to do. And I've always been interested in medicine. I was an EMT about 10 years ago when I lived in Boston. You know, I didn't do that much with it. I mostly was like the medic for like, you know, a sports game or something. And somebody would tear their ACL and I'd be like, well, you need to go to an actual ER. I can't do much for that. You know, that sort of thing.
So you were like the sideline standby.
Yeah, I did a bit of that like 10 years ago. Not quite 10 years ago, it was like 9 years ago. And then I helped out at a couple of medical emergencies in San Francisco, sort of like, you know, on the bus once, walking down the street once, that kind of thing. And I was like, I should do this again. I miss this, I like that feeling. I like the feeling of tangibility of it. Like when you work online, when you work on the internet, there are times you feel a little potentially disconnected. When somebody's like bleeding in front of you and you can do something about it, you can help them, it's a nice feeling to be able to like tangibly help someone.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Like you do know what I mean. You've done it. You did it for 6 years, you were a paramedic.
So. Yeah, I was a paramedic for 911 in Atlanta.
Nice.
And then at Grady Health System, which is a public hospital, so it's like a teaching hospital.
Sure,
and
sure.
They do all of 911 for the city of Atlanta. And then I came up here and worked for TransCare, which...
Oh, sure.
Yeah. So yeah. They augment FDNY, so they essentially, you know, are on contract with FDNY to run 911 for certain zones. So yeah. I did Montefiore in the Bronx, Brooklyn Hospital, and then Beth Israel. So I was
Sure.
like the East Village.
Yeah.
All right, we got, let's say hi to Cool Drew 100.
Cool Drew.
Cedar Bend is almost, so the new light cap is 400. So
wow.
Cedar Bend is like.
Right on there.
I haven't even seen this. All right, so that's the new Trials of Osiris pulse rifle. And he's got a really good roll with increased stability.
Oh,
Cedar Bend. If only you were here yesterday when we did trials.
We've got Bombs Fall in the chat. He is Scott Benson. He's making a really cool game. He's in chat.
Apple Hi, Scott.
Which is in chat, who had a real rad podcast and also is an artist doing cool things.
Hi,
yeah,
Adam.
So a lot of really cool people in here, actually.
What do they want us to do? Which crucible should we?
What crucible should we do? We have a few seconds now. They gotta think about it. Oh, Cedar Bend is here in chat. Hello.
Sorry,
Cedar
we're not
Bend.
In a party, but internet.
Internet stuff.
Internet stuff, you know.
Internet things and stuff. I want to ask you about a call that was memorable for you in a positive way. Here's the thing: people will ask EMTs and paramedics.
What's the worst thing you've ever seen?
Don't ask that.
Right.
Because like it
you
might be
something
genuinely upsetting.
You don't
want to
go there. Yeah. And
like,
then you're
going to
tell
died.
Them, and then they're going to be real sad, and you're going to be like, yeah. And then I like went home and had no emotion for 4 days.
Right. It's that's not a good question to ask. It's better to be like, what was an interesting call? What was like a weird, like a funny thing or a weird thing, you know, that happened that's memorable to you?
Memorable would be being accidentally pepper sprayed by the Atlanta police.
Good.
Because we had a psych patient that was in a tree and they missed him and hit me.
Ow.
And then I had to transport. And have you ever transported in the back of an ambulance with someone that was pepper sprayed?
No.
Pepper spray
not yet.
Is a, it is a, it's like an aerosol.
So it goes everywhere.
So it's everywhere.
Oh.
And then I think consistently the relationships with nurses at different hospitals, because you go to the ER and drop people off and get to know everyone. And,
yeah,
you know,
yes.
Grady was on tough times financially while we were there, and a lot of the ambulances did not have air conditioning. And this is Atlanta.
God.
It is humid as fuck in the summer. And so we would often come into the hospital looking worse than some of the patients, and they would have, you know, bottles of ice water for us, and they were always,
thank
you know.
Thank you to those people.
Yeah, they were always, like, taking good care of us. By the way, which crucible did we hear about?
Yeah, it's, nobody seems to be talking about that. They want to hear about milk. Do you actually wash pepper spray off with soap? Do you use milk?
We have, milk is actually, I think, the best. It's, water is obviously, worsens it because there's two types of pepper spray and I can't remember them right now, so I don't want to say an
That's
error
okay.
And then someone on Twitch would be like, oh, clearly it's chemical B429A or whatever, but it reacts to you know, body fluid. So it's designed to burn where your eyes are because your eyes are, you know, moisturized.
A lot of moisture.
Yeah, so water is a bad move.
So like, do you use whole milk only or is 2%?
2%, I don't know. I wouldn't be throwing almond milk.
Oh, sorry, they asked for supremacy. I missed that.
You can do that. Oh, good.
Clearly chemical B2A, yes. Sorry, yes.
Milk that was memorable.
Yeah, that sounds bananas, yeah.
I'm trying to think positive. You know, there's a lot of calls that stuck with you. Most of what you do when you run 911, though, is not, you know, it's not life-saving,
yeah.
You know?
There's a lot of routine to
there's a lot, like, yeah, there's
flyers,
a lot of, like,
you know?
There's a lot of people that are lost in the healthcare system.
Yeah.
And they can't get a doctor's appointment, they don't have health insurance, they have diabetes, they need to get more medicine, so going through, you know, and if they go into the ER at a public hospital, they're gonna wait forever, so you take them in an ambulance sometimes. And different states and, you know, counties have different rules for what you can and can't transport. But that's it's a lot of education. It's a lot of explaining, like, you need to take your medicine and this. Yeah, how to take care of yourself. And it's interesting. This show, I've been watching, have you seen High Maintenance yet?
No.
It's this HBO show about a weed dealer, but it's a character study of all of the people that he visits. So it's all of his clients, and they're all, you know, you know someone, whether you love it or hate it, you've met someone like almost all
for
of
sure.
his clients. And I think working on the ambulance was very similar for me.
Yes.
You know, it's like a character study of, and I was young, you know, I was 19 as a paramedic, which is the lead, like, on most calls.
Yeah, who has the most certification in the field,
In emergency medicine, it goes EMT basic. Some states have a EMT intermediate or advanced, and then paramedic, and that depicts on what you can and can't do in the field, what medications you can give.
I'm just a basic, just so y'all know.
But, again, 80% of the calls, a basic will run. And in New York, because we're so close to all of the emergency rooms, 911 for trauma is a basic call.
Basic job. Yeah.
Scoop them onto a stretcher, secure them,
stop
put them
the
on a backboard,
ABCs.
And just haul ass.
Yeah.
Whereas in Atlanta, you know, you would have a trauma call that could be a much longer ride into the hospital. So in New York, I was just doing medical calls, which a lot of times is carrying someone down a 6-floor walk up that has CHF or, you know, something like that.
Yeah.
Congestive heart failure.
We have a lot of...
A lot of questions.
Well, no. I was going to say, so I'm in Bushwick.
So you volunteer?
I volunteer in Bushwick, and it's the Ridgewood Volunteer Ambulance Corps. That's who I volunteer
so with. Awesome. Do you have a uniform that says that?
Yeah, I have a uniform that says it.
So good.
Little patches. I have a dress uniform, too. We had a new ambulance dedication a few weeks ago, and so I had to wear a dress
uniform. You got a dress up?
Yeah, I had, like police... I went to a police store to get, like, an official...
A blues. Right?
Blues. I had to get my blues, which is amazing. You should see me in a police store. I mean, if you know anything about me, how I feel politically about everything, it's like Danielle in a police store was like, what? But funny and totally good. I go like, I went twice in like 4 days at the beginning of the month because I was like, I'm going to do some traveling and then I'm going to start a new job, so I want to get my shifts done early. And within those days, I had both the most serious medical call and the most serious trauma that I've done personally. So the serious medical call was like basically pre-stroke. Dude's blood pressure was in the 240s. It was intense. So we got him to the hospital. He was hopefully okay. And then we had a pretty severe MVA, a pin.
That's one of those calls.
Somebody was T-boned in their car and trapped in their car, and the fire had to get the jaws of life out. We cut him out of the car. We cut the car around him, got him out, and he was able to move everything, and he was basically alert the whole time. So like that's not the worst thing, but it was intense. It was like a pretty decent sized accident, basically.
The firefighters on those calls are just—they're
into it.
They get people out of situations that are insane.
Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah, it's very, it definitely has given me a different view of New York. we have a lot of like minor assaults in my neighborhood. Just a whole lot of people who either got drunk and got in a fight, or got drunk and hurt themselves, or just got punched.
We had that in, when I was at Beth Israel, it's East Village.
Sure.
Friday, Saturday night.
Sure. Yep.
Got lots a lot of twisted that. Ankles in their
yep.
cocktail heels.
People get drunk and hurt themselves a lot.
Yeah, and New Year's Eve, and for some reason Mother's Day. I don't know why Mother's Day.
Because Mother's Day is like...
Mother's Day is the most violent day
central.
In Atlanta. It is. It's legit. It's a fact. You can look it up. Mother's Day in Atlanta has the most shootings and crazy shit.
Oh my
and it's
God.
Like, I don't know why. I think
it's just moms getting
I think it's it has night. To also do with the temperature, you know, like we're... Ooh.
Yeah, that's real. Like, you really do, especially, so, you know, in New York, we have pretty extreme heat and pretty extreme cold here. So it's
yeah,
like, and you get serious emergencies depending on the season, you know.
It's, oh, and I'm not, you know, I don't like keep up with astrology or any of that stuff, but like there's 100% merit to the lunar phases and like, holy shit, everyone is crazy tonight, or...
Maybe it's because we like made it a myth and then people believe it. And like subconsciously believe that and will act crazy, I don't know.
Well, what freaks me out though is like, you know, I have paramedic friends in Atlanta and San Francisco now, and you know, it would be the same thing, which is not just seasonal or weather related. You know, it'd be like, wow, we had like, 8 psych calls tonight.
Oh
and,
God! Yep. I've had many psych calls, for sure.
That's it, and that's where you
you know.
That's where it's just as important as a medical or a trauma call, but you know the tools you have to work with are much different, and it's
yes.
like personality based. And you know I've had to talk some people through some. Very
some tough times.
Yeah. Very
seriously tough times.
Very shitty things, and you know, and it's like someone, if someone attempts suicide, you take them to the hospital, or if someone is talked off of a ledge by the police, you then take them to the hospital, and you're the one that's gotta.
They need to be evaluated. They need to get further care. You know, it's.
Yeah, and you're the one that's transporting them between.
Yeah.
Psych unit, short term, long term. So. Yeah, I learned a lot. You know. About just, I think myself as a person, just through all of those experiences.
I feel like I've learned so much this year, like being an EMT again. And also, like I said, I mostly did sports games the last time I was an EMT. So like actually being on an ambulance and like being in
I'm at the bottom.
Brooklyn and Queens
Sorry,
in
Internet.
An ambulance. Oh, that's all right. We're having a good chat.
Let's.
Has been very instructive. And it really makes you feel like a part of the community, for sure. Like, you really are meeting people. And, you know, they say this all the time, but, like, yeah, you're seeing people on their bad day. So, like, you're seeing the unfiltered stuff sometimes. And I actually like that about it. I like that it's completely real and you can't. I don't know. Like I said earlier, like there are aspects of our job that like we spend so much time online that sometimes it can feel. I feel a little bit of a disconnect sometimes. And
totally.
Sometimes it's like that's real. That's happening right now. Like somebody's bleeding. Somebody needs help. Like, or even the calls that are not like that exciting. Like somebody still needed help. They needed assistance with something. And like, it can be nice to feel that tangibility.
Have you? Have you gotten a call for like an older person to like feed their cat or anything yet?
No.
Yeah, that happens a
no,
lot.
No feeding their cat, although I probably would because I
oh,
love
totally.
Cats.
Yeah.
I love cats. I love dogs and cats. I've got 2 cats and a dog, so.
Oh but, yeah. I've seen your Instagram.
You've seen my Instagram. Pets all the time. This is the late night medical and pet talk. Stream.
Welcome to medical pet talk. I think we did pretty good as esports announcers earlier today.
Yeah, we did.
I
was proud of that. I was proud of our work.
I think we have a future should this or EMTing not work out.
Yeah, you know.
Oh shit, this guy's right here.
Yeah, it's really, yeah, it's good. It's good. I am a little worried about my first really bad call. I'm worried about, like, how that'll affect me, for sure. You don't have to, like, I know, I would never ask you for hearing about bad stories. Bad stories are rough, for real. But I, like, I'm just a little worried that I'll be like, oh, man, I don't know if I can do this. You know.
In the moment, you will be fine, Danielle.
Yeah.
In the moment, you'll be thinking about your
ABCs. Like,
yeah. You'll be running through. Okay, what do I need to do? And it's all procedural. You know, it's like I need to do this and this and then this, and you'll be fine. Yeah. But I just think where you have to have a good outlet is the problem I had was I wasn't talking to anyone about what was happening at work. You know, I went to work, I didn't tell my roommate what happened, I didn't tell my girlfriend at the time, I didn't tell my best friend. I was just kind of like, oh yeah, some crazy shit happened. And it's like you want to leave it at work, you know? It's like feels natural to just want to leave it at work.
Yeah.
But what started to happen over a while is that I started to become less and less emotional.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
To good and bad things, and just shit.
Yeah. They tell us in EMT school class, whatever.
Yeah, like look out for burnout, and here are the signs.
Look out for burnout, and talk to somebody. You having problems? Talk to somebody. But it's also like a culture of like, you know, it still definitely has that like.
You're going for it, but it's not a good move. All right.
Oh, hey.
But I would have a hard time.
It's not a touchy-feely environment.
No.
Let's put it that way.
Not at all.
It is like a very.
Everyone here's been to a hospital, right? And like interacted with nurses, like you know.
Like.
It's a fucking tough job.
It's pretty no bullshit.
Yeah.
Like it's and I'm not saying that emotions are bullshit. I think talking about your feelings is pretty important. I think it's an important thing to do. I'm just saying like, the environments that you're in, as in EMS are like pretty no bullshit with like people who are very like. There's some black humor, but it's not really like, hey man.
It gets dark.
How you doing?
It gets dark.
It can be a little dark sometimes. So if you also
ooh, arrow
have a job
on
like
arrow.
That, talk. Find somebody who you can talk to, and talk to them. You know.
I mean, you're older than I was when I was doing it.
Yeah.
I was just out of. High school barely, right? I was a kid,
yeah,
so.
Yeah.
In hindsight, I would have had like a good therapist.
Yeah, somebody
something
you
like
really
that you can talk to about, like, yeah. Because I just got numb, and I got numb to good and bad, and you know, like someone would, like a friend of mine would have someone in their family pass away or whatever, and I'd be like, that's really unfortunate. You know what I mean? It's just
right,
not.
Right, just like no affect.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Somebody is sharing, I really appreciate this talk because the EMS crew that picked me up when I was suicidal, they were incredible to me. I really appreciate them so much.
Oh, that's awesome.
There's a lot of people in here just talking like, thanks to, you know, somebody else earlier, sorry I missed that, but somebody else earlier had said, thanks to the folks who got me somewhere fast enough that I didn't become, you know, paraplegic. Like, thanks EMS. So some folks who are appreciating that.
That's awesome.
For sure, which is awesome.
Renegade Mike. It's always good when you hear that like someone had a good experience because you want that to be the case, you know?
Yes.
And it's like people are fallible in every industry.
Yes. There's shitheads. Literally
there's shitheads
everywhere.
There's shitheads, there's shitheads that sell cars.
Yep.
Like the person that sold that used car to your mom in Fantasy Boston.
That's right.
Yep.
What a dick.
What a dick.
You know?
And there's shitheads in every industry. And it's always good to hear. When someone had a good experience or they felt taken care of or they felt just considered.
Yeah.
So.
That's, you know, again, people don't call 911 when they're having a great day.
Right.
And things are going well. Like, it's shit sucks when
you're meeting everyone at the absolute worst. Most of us are composed most of the time, right? This is like,
this
get
is a
up,
bad
get
day.
Out. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're meeting them at their absolute worst.
Yeah. And, like, I have to say, sounds like. Oh, somebody's saying, hey, folks in stream, you don't need to have a work situation like that to be able to, you know, need to talk to somebody if you're feeling depressed. You know, anybody
absolutely,
can have it.
No.
Please talk to someone. they're saying, I live a boring life. I still need to survive sometimes. Like, I need to talk to people. Like, no matter what's going on in your life, please do find the ways of expression and the things that help you. I know that, like, talking it out doesn't even work. Some people need to do something else. Maybe they need to just spend time with somebody, or they just need to, like, do certain things to relax. Whatever works for you, as long as it's not hurting another person, do it. Find it, do it. If you gotta talk it out, even if it's hard, talk it out.
So, a really funny thing that my therapist, this is not the Instagram account, my therapist says, but that my actual couples therapist told me was they were at a conference of all of the leading counselors across the country, right? Like, all of the leaders of the field, their colleagues they respected, like, people they looked up to so much. And they had a keynote speaker who was someone that, you know, everyone was really, really excited about. And they asked everyone on their name tag as this kind of exercise to get to know each other better, to write down what their flaw was, like, what they were, what their biggest fear and flaw was. And almost 90% of the people who are all, like, master's degrees and, you know, treating, like, leaders of the field wrote that, like, that I'm a fraud, or that I'm not good enough.
Imposter syndrome kind of.
You know what
stuff.
I mean?
Yeah.
And it's just like, I think stories like that, it's like, you are never alone.
Yes.
In insecurity and fear and all of the stuff that, I think it's, those are natural human, like, we wake up like that.
Yes, we all have that stuff. We live in a pretty complicated and sometimes brutal world, and it does some bad things to us sometimes, so, yeah.
And
man.
Talking to people is the first step to, like, oh, this is not something that, like, no one, like, none of us are terminally unique, luckily.
Yeah.
Like, there's a chance that everyone has experienced, there's someone out there, at least, that has experienced exactly the same thing and got to the other side.
Yeah. Yes. Absolutely. Somebody's asking, does imposter syndrome ever stop? I don't think it does.
No, I mean, because you approach every new situation in your life. You start a new job this week.
Yeah, 2 days ago.
And it's like the same thing, like, when you start that first day of school, I think it's just like,
totally.
You're fucking terrified,
right? I was
like,
I hope everybody likes me. Hope the other kids think
I'm terrified, nice. And we apply the same fear and insecurity and everything to these situations, even though we know we're going to be okay.
Yeah.
We treat it like this thing that's never, I don't know if I'm going to get through this, because even though it's the same fear and insecurity and the same self-doubt, it's new, and that's...
We're not always good at new. Humans aren't always good at new.
And Joel isn't always good at Destiny to that point.
You know?
Or keeping Ball Cam on in Rocket League.
Ball Cam.
So I don't play with Ball Cam. Can we talk about that, chat?
Yeah, I know about Ball Cam.
Do you play Rocket League?
Played it like a year and a half ago.
So when I use Ball Cam, I will often miss the ball if it's a simple, straightforward shot. But I guess we can do another segment with
Shko. We can totally play Rocket League after this.
And Cool Cole.
If you want to.
Because they were like surprised, but we didn't have time to do our 30-minute training session in which we would ask all of these questions.
Yeah, it got mashed in a little bit. Ball cam's a touchy subject, says Renegade Mike.
Thank you, Renegade Mike.
Touchy. Very controversial in chat, apparently. Oh, man. Yeah, no, it's, God. It can be. All I want to say, and just in general, is that emotional intelligence has to do with kind of knowing yourself and knowing what you need. And it's always okay to need something. But also be thoughtful. Be thoughtful about other human beings, what they need. This is like the psych hour.
Yeah.
Welcome
to Joel and Daniel.
Welcome.
Power hour.
We're talking about medical stuff, psychological stuff. Rocket League. You know what? God of Wog here says, as long as you're having fun, it doesn't really matter what cam you use.
I'm gonna get that printed on a t-shirt.
Like that attitude, thank you.
Life motto.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you for being a friend.
Oh, I missed, that was supposed to be a really nice slow-mo kind of death from above moment.
Oh man. So what made you interested in becoming a paramedic out of high school?
So I worked at a, I had some weird jobs. I worked at an auto body shop as the kind of like grunt, you know? I would like empty oil and like take out the trash and car parts and all that stuff. And yeah, and I had a interesting kind of situation. I ended up being living on my own like pretty early, like 17. And I got this like, okay, I could do this PA thing. Like I could go to PA school, which is right, it's a physician assistant is right below a doctor.
Yeah.
So you still go through pre-med and then you take, it's roughly half of the time it takes to go to medical school.
Yes.
I met a couple of people that were paramedics. I was looking for a new job and I was like, I can do this and like work in medicine, pay my way through medical school. Or at least pay my way through pre-med.
Yes.
And it was a start. And then I did it and I, you know, I really enjoyed it. But then at the end of it, I was like beginning to get very burnt out on medicine. So it's kind of made me happy that I didn't go, you know, that's another thing with our college system is like pick out what you want to do and then go figure it out for 4 years, for medical school for 8 years.
Yeah.
And then I hope that you really like it.
Yeah.
That's kind of a little fucked up,
yeah.
Right?
Not the best.
And there's other countries where you take a year off before you go to school and you intern, you know, and decide, is this the field that I want to work in? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Or they require you to intern for a year or two. Yeah, because like what, you know, I actually had a girl in my paramedic class that went to EMT school. They always recommend you go EMT first, yeah. Work, and then go to paramedic school. She went straight through EMT to paramedic, and then doing her ride-alongs realized that she was incredibly motion sick.
Oh no.
So she had gone through essentially 3 years of school, but couldn't ever ride in the back of an ambulance without taking Dramamine.
That's awful.
Super shitty.
I mean, I can see how that could happen. It's a little wacky back there sometimes.
It's a little wacky.
I pretty much stay in the back. Like, I only ride in the front if there's only two of us. So on a volunteer service like mine, we try to ride in three. So we ride with two if we need to, but like, we try to ride.
Get those orbs. Get those orbs.
Just extra hands, extra, you know, extra arms to lift people.
Yeah.
For sure, so that's a lot.
Especially in New
do.
York, there's no elevators.
Yeah,
you gotta
oh
have
God.
Those extra arms.
Brooklyn and Ridgewood, yeah.
And the fire department does not like carrying people down for you.
Nope.
Oft. Nope.
No, they don't love that.
They don't love that.
Even though they're all like, not all.
They're all.
But they tend to be like dudes with muscles.
Yeah.
Or ladies with muscles. Like some people with muscles. Human beings with muscles.
Humans with muscles.
Humans with muscles.
Firefighter story.
Yeah, it's a.
I want to try out a new primary. Let's.
I was actually worried about that when I started riding, when I started volunteering. I was like, I don't know if I'm going to barf all over everybody. I did. Oh, here's the bad call that I've been on. This is not a like a bad story. It's more funny and embarrassing. I fainted this summer in a patient's stairwell.
You did?
I did.
While carrying someone?
No, thank God. We weren't carrying her down.
It's super hot.
It
dehydrated.
Was so hot. I was drinking water. This is the other thing. I was drinking so much water because it was during the heat wave of like, it was over 100 degrees and with full humidity. And there was air conditioning in this woman's apartment, but like not in the stairwell, of course.
This
you know, fourth floor in Bushwick. Like, I like went to my partner. I said, literally, yo, I'm going to faint. Walked over to like a corner where the patient couldn't see me, conked out.
You're like, I'm gonna faint, and then you fainted.
I did, yeah.
A woman of her word, I appreciate it.
Well, I wanted her to know. And actually, the neighbors were so nice. They got me water, they like stayed with me while my partner ran down to get me like, you know, something like an ice pack or something, and like, just so nice. That's the other thing. New Yorkers are so much nicer than what everybody says they are.
Oh.
Who actually live here.
Yeah, absolutely.
I've been here for a year as of tomorrow. Today's Halloween.
Well, happy anniversary.
The year I came here. Yeah. One full year. So, yeah, as somebody here is saying, legit heat stroke can't be stopped by water. Once that process starts, just find a spot to pass out.
Yep.
It was rough. I was very embarrassed. But,
and you're in, like, really good shape.
I'm in good shape, yeah. I mean, like, I run. I, you know, I have a low resting heart rate. Oh, yeah, so Ryan Franklin here is asking how you transitioned from EMT stuff to what you do now, publishing.
Yeah, that's a weird one. I kind of talked about it a little bit last night.
Oh, you talked about last night.
No, but it's a new night. So I moved to New York in 2008. I transferred to BMCC. I transferred my paramedic license because different states have reciprocity.
Oh, that's right. Special.
Yeah, they have.
Actually.
Yeah, so all I had to do was attend a 2-day thing and then take the New York test, and then they would grant you reciprocity, which is honoring your license.
Because Georgia, I imagine, is national registry.
Yeah, national registry. And, so I had started to sense that I didn't want to stay in medicine for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
I transferred to BMCC, which is a borough of Manhattan community college. Nice. Just like a good city-run school here. And I was going to go for a marketing program just because it seemed super vague.
Yeah.
Like marketing.
Marketing, cool.
I'll just work in. It's like when people go for a business degree. It's like, well, what are you going to do? Business.
Business.
And my mom was in marketing growing up.
Oh, nice.
In Atlanta. So I was just like, I'll do that. And then someone that I met through a friend of a friend had a startup software company. It was very boring. They made software that, like, analyzes documents from printers and uses OCR to then input it into a database and different workflow for different types of industry.
That exciting stuff.
Super exciting. Yeah, I used to go to like print and copier conferences in Mahwah, New Jersey. Shout out Mahwah. And they were like, why are you going to school for something that I could like give you a job doing? Which is kind of weird. Did that. They folded.
Oh, no.
So got laid off in 2009, right after the financial collapse in New York.
Oh, good, yeah.
So I was on fun employment for about 6 months, and then I got a job producing. I run a record label, and I started the Brooklyn Electronic Music Festival.
Amazing.
And I did a monthly party, so I've been producing a bunch of events just as fun. I never thought this was gonna be my job, right?
Yeah.
And then someone needed like dire help producing an event for an agency in the city, like experiential, which is like essentially a fancy word for throwing events for clients.
Sure.
For an experiential agency, I did that. I did a bunch of little odd jobs and just kind of they kept asking me to come back. I was freelance. And then I was like, whoa, I'm like producing the Wired store, you know, like their pop-up holiday thing. And from there I went to this agency called Mother, which is a really good ad agency based out of London and one in New York.
Nice.
And then my friend knew I did the festival and the parties and the record label. And was like, Vice is starting an electronic music site and they want to talk to you about running it.
That's amazing.
And here I am.
And now here you are in a 72-hour life.
And I think about like how bummed I was to be laid off in 2009 when
I was in grad school.
You were in
just
grad school.
Finishing grad
school. Oh, so that was probably a good feeling.
I was terrified.
You were like, oh, jobs are going to be great.
I was like, oh, 170K. Of student debt.
Yes.
What a great idea.
What a great idea.
This was good. This was smart.
Let's go get that job. Oh, wait.
Yeah. I was just finishing up.
So, you know, being unemployed and it's just talk about belittling. Talk about a test of your self-worth. You're like, send out your resume to 50 people a day and you're anyone you can friend of a friend that could remotely get you an interview. Nothing. And I was so bummed out that that company folded. But when you look back at it, it's like if all that stuff hadn't happened, I wouldn't have. Yeah, so. And I'm not working in the copier industry, so.
That's amazing. That's a pretty awesome.
No shade
journey.
To anyone that works in the copier industry.
It just sounds like this is maybe a little more you.
Yeah, I'm playing Destiny at like 4 a.m.
Yeah, you are.
What time is it for?
Just about 3:50.
All right, so let's do one more of these in Destiny and let's switch up the game.
Yeah.
Cool Drew, you've been holding it down
cool,
in Cedar
Drew,
Bend.
Thank you.
I'm sorry I'm at the bottom of the team. This TV it must not be responsive enough.
People are talking about 4 a.m. and making bad choices.
Oh yeah, like, what did Austin, isn't that how he closed out the game? It's 4 a.m.
Let's make some bad choices.
Yeah.
Oh. Danica's coming in soon as well. She might be relieving me. She might be my relief, the relief pitcher.
So yeah, you need to sleep too, because we got to finish.
We got to finish strong. So I'll probably be taking a break in a few minutes. But yeah, do folks have more questions in chat? Yeah, some folks are talking about anxiety. I'm super open about this. I have like real bad anxiety, actually. I have panic attacks sometimes. You know, I take medicine for it, I do all the stuff. That's why I exercise.
That's why
so
you
much.
Exercise every day.
Actually, it's like, you know, the best way
it's
of
crucial.
Like, staying even keel.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, it's like a thing I totally talk about online because I've always been like, well, you know, whatever. Might as well be open. If it helps one person ever, then great. But yeah, it's like, it's not easy sometimes, but. You take your medicine, you do your workouts. I have good friends, I have good family. They help a lot, you know? These are all good things. Thank you for being here, friends. Thank you for being here on this beautiful stream. 4 a.m.
Beautiful Twitch chat.
Day 3. About to be day 4, sort
of. About to be day 4.
Kind of.
Kind of-ish. exercise. Helps clear my head so much. And especially when you have a computer desk, typing, editing, whatever. You're editing all day and like working on keynote presentations and
Bravo team.
All that fun stuff. But like, even if you can't run, you know, or you can't do something like yoga, stretches for 30 minutes, like all of that stuff, it just makes such a huge difference.
Yeah.
I wonder if a lot of the streamers, like the professional streamers, because you're sedentary for such a long time, I wonder if
they have their routines?
Yeah, like, I'm just curious what their routines are to...
Yeah, I would love to hear about that, too. I mean, like, I know I'm ridiculous with my workout schedule, but, you know, it helps you stay focused. I know a lot of esports athletes actually do work out quite a bit.
Yeah,
and it's stay focused.
Yeah, and it's been like talked about. It seems more and more.
Yeah.
And at Waypoint, as you saw with our GoldenEye tournament.
Yeah, that was our esport.
We are your destination for esport.
It was the finest esport.
The number one.
Yeah, 4 a.m. Let's make some chocolate pudding. I'm at that point where I'm very hungry and I'm very tired.
Let's go back.
You have that thing where you're really hungry and really tired, do you do the thing where you just go to bed? You're just like tired wins?
You know what?
I
like to eat because it's one less thing to think about when you're going to bed. Yeah. I won't eat a lot.
A little small meal?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to shout out my girlfriend, Michelle, who's put up with me this whole weekend. I went home. She got us some soup dumplings. I ate those and passed out, and it felt good. So I would highly recommend, not saying you're going to get some soup dumplings right now. Yeah, but have a little snack. I also brought some protein shakes and stuff if you want something simple.
Oh, those are good. I've been eating a lot of protein bars. We have a lot of those at this nice spot.
Yeah, we have some bananas that just got in, but they're not ripe yet.
Okay, I'll have those tomorrow, I guess. You know, I want to shout out to my girlfriend too. She is currently dealing with my dog who's been pooping all over the floor all week.
Oh no,
he's
solo
been, like,
on a
shit floor.
Pooping pupper.
He's a pooping pupper. Pupper. He sure is. Dealing with our dog and also, you know,
is it,
hanging
so
out
it's
with
a
our
puppy.
Cats. He's a year old.
He's a year old, so he's
just
still
turned a year old this month.
He's still kind of figuring everything out.
He's very young, he's incredibly anxious, and he was definitely abused. So
oh.
He has some.
Yeah, he's gonna be sketchy for a while. Yeah.
Yeah, he's got some stuff. His name is Drake.
Is he a rescue?
He's a rescue. Yeah. All of our animals are, but like, you know, when you get kittens, they're pretty much usually. but puppies might be.
Yeah.
Little.
Cats, it's kind of.
Cats
like.
Are a little easy. I mean, let's be honest. Cats are the easiest. Cats probably have the most sort of like input to output ratio for a pet. Like, if you get a cuddly cat, all you gotta do, you feed them, you play with them a little, you clean up their poo, they use the bathroom in a sandbox, and it's great. And you've got like a companion who loves you. Now, if you get a cat who doesn't love you, that's the problem. But dogs, you have to walk them, you have to feed them, you have to groom them.
Sorry.
Oh, I'm just talking about
dogs. No, please.
They poop all over the place if they're not super great on the whole toilet bit. And,
Do you use a puppy pad? Those have always kind of freaked me out.
We do use a puppy pad.
I could see, like.
Yeah.
Is better than nothing.
He's
right?
Also small. Like, he's a Chihuahua Terrier mix. So he's a little guy.
He lost an orb off the edge.
He's like a 14-pound dog. So I'm fine using the puppy pads for a small dog.
Now, I've seen people, and it's supposedly really hard, but
no,
they've been able to toilet train their cats.
I've seen that.
And it's like a litter box that you slowly move up
to the toilet,
very gradually,
to
make it, you know.
The thing is, cleaning litter is so easy. I don't mind that step at all.
What if you could train your puppy to do it?
Yeah, if I could train the puppy, that would be the real thing. Or like training the puppy to use a litter box would be amazing too. Like, I know that's possible, not easy, but possible. Our dog is not the brightest as well as kind of his other problems, so I don't know. I mean, it's entirely possible that he might have to live with my mom for a little bit. So my girlfriend is like kind of had it up to here with our dog.
Yeah.
She's like a little bit done with our dog right now, so. He might live with grandma for a little bit, which would be fun. Grandma loves him.
Good. It's good to have.
But yes, my girlfriend deserves a medal for this, I mean, this whole week, because obviously, you know, you've been here. Like, it's been
we're tired now, but we've been to put this together and to.
Yeah, it's like we're a little tired, and our significant others have been, you know, really great in picking up the slack. Patrick's wife, shout out, dealing with a newborn.
Oh yeah.
You know, like so. Thank you,
and
friends and family. Thank
in terms of taking care of people, our moderators all
Mods,
weekend
thank you
putting
so
in,
much.
Burning the midnight oil, keeping everybody positive.
Yeah.
Keeping the nasty Johns out of the chat.
That's right. Thank you, folks.
Why am I on the bottom? I
just want to say thank you to all. Oh man.
And people keep asking, we are archiving everything.
Yes, we are.
Some of it we're doing a little manually, like we're gonna upload our own version of that whole segment. And some of it's gonna happen just naturally on Twitch. The first day on Twitch, we had to restart the stream to get some VOD thing working correctly.
So we're
but it'll
just
all be up, nothing will be lost.
Nothing will be lost, all of our great content
Knock
will
on.
Be here. So it looks like, yeah, I know. My earpiece is actually not working, so I'm not sure if they're trying to talk to me. But we should probably take a quick break.
Yeah.
Switch to something else, and we'll see if Danica is awake. potentially. Let's see what else is up. But yeah, I'll take us out momentarily. So thank you so much, everybody, for playing Destiny. This is the late night block where we're just hanging on. We're just going. We're powering through. We're very happy to be here.
Talking puppers and positivity.
Talking puppers, positivity, medical training, all sorts of good stuff going on here. So don't go anywhere. We're going to take a very quick break. We're going to be back with another game.
Have you ever done radio?
I've never done I do a podcast.
College radio, though. You were like 100% shoo-in for college
radio.
I've
never done radio. I guess podcast. Well, thank you.
You're listening to 88.5.
Thank you so much, Joel. And thank you, viewers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being with us. 72 games in 72 hours. Waypoint.vice.com. It's our website. Please visit it. Thank you so much, and we'll be right back.